Everybody, welcome to my channel. It's twitch.tv/FeliciaDay, and it's my space, right? You like it, right? My hair looks good. I did this for you. Okay, anyway, I did it also because it's my birthday tomorrow.
Yeah. And
thank you. But I wanted to be able to get an amazing D&D session in before we break for July, because some people are going on road trips. Some of the people are just like, let's get COVID. No, I'm just kidding. Sorry, Amy.
Oh my god.
But we're very excited to be here to do this one shot tonight. Now, Vork, I don't know where Jeff Lewis went with his children. I don't know if they're I think they're on a road trip, so God bless him. But we have an amazing guest star tonight. Will Wheaton is here to play Fox, we'll see what happens. We're so excited to have him back, and we're going to have a fun D&D. Obviously, you know us. We're so professional in our rules and stuff like that. But anyway, we're going to be giving away one thing during the stream, Dragonburns Design, designs.com. Guys, go to their .com, check their stuff out. We're not sponsored by them, but they did give all of us this amazing dice box that they handmade for everybody. And they're an indie company. It's a guy and his daughter. They do everything, and it's just really beautiful, and they're giving away one of their boxes. They're sending it directly, so we can't sign it, but they will send it to somebody in the U.S. over the intermission at 8:30. And if you guys like our shirts, this is the last weekend you can get the shirt. I think they are limited edition, but they held them over for this stream, and the pin, which we sold out of, and they had to order another one. So the pin, 100% of proceeds go to Black Girls Code, which is amazing. Charitable organization. I actually did a charity push on my Facebook page. Facebook's the devil, but we raised over $10,000 already just for that, for my birthday. So thank you for anybody who did that. And portions of the shirt will go to No Kid Hungry, but the pin, 100% of the proceeds go to the Black Girls Code. So it's a great one, and grab it while you can, because it'll be off in a couple of days. So without further ado, I guess Will, are you excited to be here?
Yeah, I'm just realizing that I inadvertently left my godson's photos on the wall, which my sister is like, please don't do that. So, I'm Will's anxiety. How's it going? I'm super psyched to do this. I was playing in a regular campaign that just was stopped. I don't know if you guys know, but there's this pandemic going on and we can't go places. Like, you would be an asshole to go someplace right now.
Yeah, so, road trip people. What are you doing?
Boy, just bananas, right? I'm so looking forward to doing this, and I am so looking forward to having something where that's going to mark the difference from one day to another day. I'm so psyched that I'm just going to be able to be like, oh, right, it was Saturday. I think that was 3 days ago.
Well, that's why me and Amy stream. We stream a couple times a week. You stream sometimes too, right? On, is it Will Wheaton? Twitch.tv/Will Wheaton?
Yeah, so I tried to get Will W and it wouldn't let me have it for some reason. So my Twitch handle is the same as my Facebook name. Which is the same as my Instagram name, which is It's Will Wheaton.
Great. Well, everybody go there and follow him. Right. And we're just happy to have you. So anyway.
Thank you. I'm really psyched that you asked me. I really appreciate it.
Well, I have to say, the last time I ever played anything D&D related with Will Wheaton was at Gen Con, like, forever ago at that True Dungeon thing that we did live. All I remember is that you rolled a natural 20 to defeat the dragon at the end. I don't, you guys remember that?
Yeah,
I killed the dragon. Awesome. And in fact,
I
don't know if you were
there. I think you
I don't
were
remember you. You didn't roll the 20.
Amy. Yeah. Yeah.
Was
Amy,
I there?
You were there too. Yeah.
Was I there?
And in that True Dungeon, the DM of that room
holding
a giant red D20 as the dragon. So when I killed the dragon, the DM of that room gave me that red D20 and said, this is the dragon's heart.
Ooh. Oh, I remember this now. I remember that. That was really epic.
I have it. I think it's in this room. I think it's on a bookcase that y'all can't see.
Because it's the only natural 20 you have ever rolled, right?
Ever in my life. I mean, like, I used it all up. I hope you appreciate, Sandeep, I hope you appreciate it. I used it all up.
You picked your
moment. It's the one thing I remember about you. So it's really, it's cherished.
It really is impressive.
It has not been good since then.
Well, anyway, we are so happy to have you. And we are sad to miss Jeff Lewis, but he will be back whenever we come back. And check my Discord, discord.gg/FeliciaDay. For updates on our next stuff, but it won't be until after July. Okay, and without further ado, Dungeon Master Amy Vorpal, take it away.
Yay. Okay, before I do, I want to see the rest of Will's shirt, because D&D shirts, I think everyone's going to... Mm-hmm. Right now it just says roll. Oh, roll
mod. That's really good.
That's good.
That's great. Okay, cool.
That's a really good shirt.
At first I thought it was just roll, and then I was like, no, totally, we should definitely roll. And then I thought it was roll mode, and I was like, oh, like beast mode, and this makes more sense.
if context matters at all, I roll dice really badly. Like statistics weep at how consistently I roll critical failures.
I mean, it is a one. There's a one on your shirt. Yeah.
There's a one in the O.
Well, statistically, Clara, Robin, actually rolls above the possibilities that dice even have. So
rolling hundreds on D20s.
Robin, I'm here to flatten your curve.
Okay, let's get into it. Bye, Cindy.
What's he doing? He's breaking his world.
He's
oh my god.
The background.
Vanishing into the graveyard.
No, he's back.
Oh God!
That's unnerving.
Okay, he's back. Zombo's back.
Oh, Zombo.
So
I had to turn a fan on. All right, let's go.
Yeah, you definitely did. I'm glad you did that. If any of you in the audience have been following the five sessions that we played before, the Fungal Fortune with the Mushroom People, this is kind of an extension of that without taking into account too much of the craziness that happens. So without further ado, the Knights of Good have all retired to their respective living spaces in Mondopolis, the big capital city of Dragonor. A lot transpired for them last week, but instead of dealing with the looming danger they found themselves in, they decided to take some self-care time. Yeah, sure. Half of their party souls seemed to be promised to the underworld, but it wasn't like soul collection was happening today. So last week they accepted and completed their first quest ever. And y'all, they're tired. So let's see what they're up to. First off, when Bort got into town, he found out he had jury duty. So he's checking out for any new adventures. Clara, who wound up being the MVP of the adventure, knew that she would have to carry this guild on her shoulders. So even though she really wanted to go to a spa, she instead joined a gym, a spell gym, so she could carry the weight of the rest of you.
Wow.
Tink, on the other hand, went to the spa.
One sentence.
Zabu, still 100% a zombie. He went home to his mom, who didn't notice anything different except, to her pleasure, that his appetite has increased
100%. Wow. Sweet mate.
Blades began writing his memoirs, and after a bunch of false starts, crumpling parchment after parchment, dramatically throwing them on the floor, on his 69th parchment, he got to the second sentence.
Nice.
Wow. Yeah. Very nice.
Codex went back to her messy apartment with the goal of tidying and cleaning, but after a couple of days of really trying, she was still having a hard time figuring out where to begin. Mm-hmm. At that point, any distraction was welcome, so when she heard a knock on her door, she was happy to answer it and open it to see Fox.
Oh, hello, boy. Codex. Well, I'm sorry. I did not order any Tavern Dash. Hello? Wow. You know, the smell is old cheese, but I just haven't figured out how to clean it up. What? Woo, look at me. Okay. Hey. Hello, Fox. What are you doing on, what?
Fox takes a long, uncomfortable pause. Just the longest, most awkward. He is drinking in how uncomfortable this is. And he finally says, I think we are just insects. We live a bit and then die, and that's the lot. There's no mercy in things. There's not even a great beyond. There's nothing.
I think the auditions for the little theater down are next door. So the Groundling Theater, yeah, that one's maybe. This is very awkward. What are you doing? I'm just gonna say it. This is really awkward, and I hope to never see you again. And I've been to a sorcerer therapist, and she tried to erase you from my brain, and clearly that didn't work because all the insecurity, and I am sweating under my butt. You know that area with the under the butt, so it just starts to drip under. It's butt cleavage that is sweating because I just don't know what to tell you right now, and I have not seen you since spell school, and this is unwelcome. I thought we were going to agree to move to different continents. And why is this happening right now? Is there a reason? Are you, what? Why can I stop talking?
Yeah, keep talking.
I've been many places. I've seen many things. I've slept with many women.
Okay, but why? Why now? Why right now? That's exactly what made us break up in sophomore year during prom, because we graduate at sophomore level in spell school.
I know what happened in spell school.
I am just saying it for my neighbor, Ruthie. She's a troll, okay? She already, I know you have the cup on the side of the wall, Ruthie. I know it.
You got an associate's degree in spell school, a two-year program there.
It's a two-year.
It's totally a community school. I refused to participate in the academic system, but I needed the parchment.
Oh boy. Okay. What do you want from me, Fox? Why are you here? I've already asked that four times in different ways. We need to wrap. Listen, I'm going to call. Listen, I'm going to call. Guild, right? So good. Here, pigeons.
Blows in the magic conch.
Oh, fucking pigeon attack.
What is that? Oh, we caught. It pooped on me.
Get in here.
This can only be Codex.
Just kind of get to my house, okay?
Wait, but I'm in the middle of my facial.
Get to my house.
The pigeons don't have, do they have any message on them, or are they just your pigeons?
We just know their codex is shitty pigeons.
We know what a pigeon means.
Instinctively know.
We've established this code.
Codex are right. Out with
I smell my pigeon. I'm like, ah, oh, that's Codex's a cheese scent.
Ah, right, was that? I know that's my third sentence.
She needs me.
Fine,
right,
I'll go.
So the entire guild actually approaches Fox from behind, and you guys see this really strapping man in breastplate standing at Codex's door before you enter. And he does strike quite a figure. He's got a cape behind him. It's probably whistling in the wind. And he looks
haughty.
Yeah.
He's not a lot. He's fine.
Nah, he's pretty hot.
Yeah, I mean, come on. He's like a 6.5, 7.
Like a 10. 7.8.
Hey, guys.
He's a Mondopolis 9.
You can definitely sense that people are behind you, but it's not abnormal for you to be talked about by other people. You're used to,
of course,
catching, turning heads.
I presume that at this point, Codex is again talking about something a lot. So I very gently just put my finger out, and then I slowly turn around. I keep my finger on her as I talk. Mm. Hello, Knights of Good.
Oh God, he's old.
Yeah,
hi. Oh, he can't even hold his finger up anymore because he knows it's true. He knows it's true.
Thank you, Jake. hi guys.
Hi.
Yeah, we got your pigeons.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, this is the reason right here. We had a thing in sophomore of spell school. the two-year degree. You know, you guys, I told you I was accredited. Would you want to see my diploma? It's under some beef.
No, you bring this up a lot.
Tell us why this really attractive guy's on your doorstep. He's
okay.
Zabu.
Okay, yeah, Zabu. God, you, look, you just lost a fingernail. Pick yourself up off the floor. Listen,
I just
this
noticed
is
something above the smell of stale cheese.
Okay, is that probably is the rotting flesh of one of my party members. Anyway, this
I
is
I tried talcum powder everywhere, but there's so many loose skin flaps.
You're gonna
he's very moist all of the time.
God, you're gonna get cervical cancer. Okay, listen, guys, this is my Fox. This is my guild. This is Clara, Tinkerbala, Blades, and Zabu. And this is my ex, Fox. And for some reason, he has shown up to my doorstep. People who do that are so creepy. And what I want to do is what I just need some backup, y'all. Okay, I need some.
Are we Codex, fighting this man?
Codex, you actually hear from all of you probably hear next door. Y'all should make out.
Oh, Ruthie. God damn. Ruthie?
Ah, classic Ruthie.
That's so Ruthie.
Yeah.
Who do you want to make out? Who do you want to make out, Ruthie?
Which combination of people?
If I had it, well, I didn't know I had a choice. I thought it was just you and the strapping man. But now I want you and the ranger. I want the ladies.
Okay. Ruthie.
I mean, we should give it a shot.
Okay, just no. Everybody just stop, okay? Stop it.
Okay.
Let's just come into my apartment, okay? Slam.
Okay.
But no, Ruthie. Okay, fine, Ruthie. Come on in. Come on in, Ruthie. Okay. I need as much wings. I need as many wings as I can, okay?
Wait, is Fox outside?
No, we're all inside.
We're all inside right now. The old guy's inside. Okay.
Okay. The old guy, Fox, and then the very old troll, Ruthie. But Ruthie, God, you smell like borscht.
Can I sit down?
I think he handles age very well.
Okay. I smell like the most delicious thing in this room, be honest. Borscht is so much.
She's not wrong. Borscht is welcome
sorry.
Right now.
I spent 3 days figuring out what to clean up, and it's too much. Okay, let's talk about Fox right now. Fox, just tell us why you're here.
Codex, it may come as a surprise to you to find out that I don't have many friends.
Mm. Oh, really? The guy who on our college yearbook, people said, dude, I would not want to be friends with after graduation?
Graduation?
What is that?
What kind of school is this?
Is that what?
I appreciate that you used the soft G when pronouncing graduation.
It was a dragon. Listen, the
2 year graduates of wizard school.
It was a dragon.
Okay, we believe you graduated. Okay, fine.
Okay, listen. The dean was a dragon, okay? He changed the name. Shut up. All right, listen. Why, Fox? Why?
I refuse to be governed by my lessers.
All right, so you have no friends. Why are you? Did you think that I was your friend? I think that we broke up.
Codex, we shared something. We shared something, and your guild knows. They know. They've read the fan fiction.
Did you guys know? Okay, we shared his pee-pee. All right. Wow. All right.
Yeah, you did.
That's what we shared.
Yeah, you did.
We did.
That is disgusting.
Codex, I feel that I can trust you.
It's romantic.
And get some advice.
Really? Because I can never trust you, but okay, that's fine. The whole pottery class, class, and okay.
We're healing.
Fine.
This is nice.
All right. What?
Your freakishly small, spindly hands created amazing elven pottery. Codex.
Well, thank you. I didn't know how to twirl it.
Yes, you did. Word has gotten to me that you are a successful group of questing guilders.
We do guild quests, questing guilders,
I believe.
Yeah.
We're one for Wheel. We're 100% successes.
We're 100%, yes, 100% track record.
It's come to my attention that you are successful questing guilders, and I come to you with a quest.
Oh.
You're gonna hire us?
You're gonna hire us and then
I
leave.
Will hire awesome. You and I will accompany you.
Ooh. That's so close, buddy.
The more the merrier, I guess, right?
Fraught with peril.
Excuse me. Can I ask you a question, Mr. Fox?
I'll allow it.
Is there a reason why you talk so slow?
Is there a spell to speak?
I like to feel the words.
Got it.
As they move through me.
I got to be honest. I've been on the edge of my seat this whole conversation. I'm just like, it's totally working.
The
totally
insides working. Of me are just like, I'm getting a lot. And there's just a lot of.
Guys, don't fall for it. This is how he casts this sort of spell, by just lulling you into this.
Zabu,
you're so right. It's like riling me up a little bit.
Zabu,
I don't know if I like it or not.
He's very into edging, guys. Just
I've fallen hard.
I kind of like it, but I just don't know.
He's like a human ASMR.
I'm okay with edging. That's okay.
It's all right, Codex. I've fallen in love
with me.
And
congrats.
With what? Me, really? Are we getting back together? Wait, really? Oh my
Codex,
god!
I'm excited for you to meet her.
Oh. I mean, I didn't.
Now we got to live with that through the whole quest.
I was so repulsed. I couldn't help it. I couldn't help even just being, God, you're trying to beg me to get back with you after like 8 years. I mean, come on. We're so history, but I didn't know.
Wait, you were just so happy. What do you mean?
Oh, honey.
What do you mean? What are you talking about? That's not happiness.
You were so stoked just then?
No, I was crying.
Am I going to have to listen to you cry yourself to sleep for two more weeks?
Ruthie, I forgot you were here. God, Ruby, why are you
going for your snacks?
Why are you helping yourself to my like? Get out of my kitchen!
Oh, you said get in the corner. That's just where your kitchen happened to be.
Oh God. Okay, it's true.
So
it's
her name is Aristara.
Her name is Aristara.
Her name is Aristara.
A pretty,
wow, ugly, fancy name.
We shared several moments of unbridled passion.
God, you keep saying stuff like that.
Sex? Did you guys have sex?
Yeah, you could just say you boned or something.
Probably second base.
I think. Yeah.
But after our last encounter, when I professed to her my undying love, in the morning, I found that she'd been snatched from our coital bed.
Are you sure she didn't run away?
Yeah, did she run away?
She just broke up with you. Left. It's called ghosting. With
is there a
Codex? You're so like. In the know. That's
only because
trendy.
Of you. No, it's only because of you.
Where do you buy coital beds?
In the bed district.
Oh, nice. I will look into it.
I mean,
you
did
don't
you go-
buy a coital bed, young man? You make a coital bed.
Oh, boy.
I'm learning stuff every day, Dad. Fox.
You call him Dad. Oh boy, we know you're an orphan. We don't want to get in your backstory, Blades. Come on.
I searched for several days to find my lady love, and I found out that she had been captured by a Medusa.
Ooh.
Are you sure she isn't like hooking up with a Medusa? Because kids do that these days too. Okay.
And what
like,
makes you think honestly, that she didn't run hot. Away?
Yeah. How did
she
you
didn't
know?
Run away.
How do you know?
You, because in the morning, because this has to happen for the fucking story, but because, is the short answer, but in the morning, you actually saw her being kidnapped and you were unable to save her because two hulking women said this is courtesy of the Medusa and were dragging her out.
Oh, you wanted to leave that part out, huh, Fox?
Yeah,
like you couldn't save your little lady.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you were not able to save her.
I choose to focus on and highlight the areas of my existence which proved satisfying to me.
This guy, he can't ever do a limerick. He would do like a five or a haiku. You couldn't do a haiku. Remember we had that one time and I was like, a haiku, Fox, do a haiku. And you were just like, it was 5 hours.
It was all downhill after that.
Yeah, it was
the
5 hours.
The middle sentence.
I recall it being 5 hours, then 7 hours.
And then 5 hours again.
5 hours again.
Oh, yeah. Nice.
That's how I recall it.
Oh, boy. Okay, so your lady, Aristara, which is a disgustingly beautiful name, she was kidnapped. You saw them, and they threatened you? They said it was courtesy of the Medusa?
Courtesy of the Medusa.
So what kind of trouble are you in with them? Huh? Because they're not just going to kidnap a beautiful Noombi. What is she, an elf or a fairy? Something gorgeous?
She's an elf. Perfect. She's a wood elf with bronze skin, and she's 5'10" and
hey,
and
I'm a wood elf.
Gorgeous.
Okay, great. Yeah.
She sounds
hotter than me.
She's. I mean, objectively.
Well, when we meet her, we can take a poll, find out.
We'll definitely judge.
I don't think she's hotter than you. But Fox is 100% more attracted to her.
Great. Okay, so what kind of trouble are you in with the Medusa clan, or is this just random?
As it turns out, it's just random.
But you put it in quotes. So
why did you do that? You didn't have to.
All right.
Yeah, so you don't know these guys. Do you know anything about their whereabouts or any clues that might...
This is the first... you're the guild.
Yeah.
Okay.
You are right there.
You're making a point.
The questers.
I'm going to do an insight check to see if I think that Fox is telling the truth when he doesn't think he's saying he doesn't have anything to do with the Medusas or a reason why they would kidnap her.
Okay.
Oh, I rolled a 15 and I have a insight of +5. I rolled a 20.
Should this be opposed?
Amazing. So, not really, because as far as you know, as far as Fox knows, he's telling you the truth.
Okay.
So, you can actually sense that he's this is the most vulnerable he's ever been. This is way more vulnerable than he's been when he was hooking up with you. The fact that he's admitting his feelings is like a big step. He's growing as a man and a person. And that's what you get from the insight. He 100% believes that he doesn't have anything to do with this Medusa. So he's coming to you very confused and vulnerable with his tail between his embarrassed legs.
Okay.
And so this just happened like last night kind of thing? Like you came from the postcodal bed to here, straight directly to here?
I spent some time, I made the postcoital bed. And then then I spent a great deal of time searching, trying to find these lady ruffians who snatched my lady fair, and could not find anything, which is why I have come to you. You have made quite a reputation for yourselves.
Really? Who? Where? On the
I mean, he's not wrong. We're pretty great.
On like a y'all were
announced at the burger ball.
Oh yeah, we were announced at the burger ball. Were you? Oh, were you at the burger?
At the burger ball?
Yeah.
I did spend some gold to do like a dragon skywriting ad for us.
Oh, that's why I got a lot of scroll requests. So, got you.
That might have been.
That's so smart.
That's really sweet of you.
Should we go to maybe your place?
Yeah, let's check the scene of the crime.
See how sad and pathetic it is.
Sure, let's go back to my place. Codex, do you want to lead?
Well, I don't want to ever hear you say that to me again. So say it to Clara or something, because I'm having a little PTSD right now. Okay.
Say it to me.
Oh, Ruthie.
Ruthie, come on.
Stay mad at you.
Silly.
Ruthie, you're not coming with us, okay?
Ruthie, you really should come
with us, Ruthie.
Ruthie, what class are you?
I'm a troll. I'm a monk. I know I look heavy in the gut, but you should see my high kicks.
You're a monk?
Does she really? Come?
Fun.
Yeah, I'm a troll monk.
Okay.
What, is that funny? Is that funny?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Is that funny?
So fast.
Maybe she should
right. You got some moves, Ruthie.
Okay, we can bring
her. Hand fight.
We can bring her. Come on, Ruthie. Let's go. Okay.
Let's do it.
Maybe she could help like Zabu with his.
Yeah. Yeah. Just pick up anything that Zabu falls off Zabu's body.
Yeah. If you could carry this leg.
Oh, yeah. I'll just carry. Yeah. I'll cradle you.
Kind of. Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah.
Okay. So Fox, where do you
live? I have a new mount.
Yeah. So if we're going to Fox's house, Fox lives actually in a really nice part of town. He's made a name for himself, even just as a solo adventurer. This obviously is something he can't take on for himself, but he's in the upper district around where you guys actually did attend the Burger Ball. So it would make sense that he would be there. And he's got a really nice corner of the building apartment with a bunch of natural light on the fourth floor of like a tower. And it's got two bedrooms and an office.
Look at all this light, guys. It's like too much light.
I don't know. Anything more than a studio is more than one person needs, really.
Nice digs, buddy.
Yeah. No, come on.
Gorgeous.
Open.
can.
Thank you. Make yourselves at home.
Yeah, so as you come in, I mean, it's very comfortable and clean, and a fire is burning in the hearth, and you see a couple of, like, one of the bedrooms is to the left and the other one is to the right, separate, you also see the living room kind of bleeds into the kitchen, and the office is towards the left bedroom.
So which is the coital bedroom?
Oh, God.
Do you have to call it that?
That's what it's called, right?
Why don't you have your sketch pad out, Blades?
Ready.
Wow.
To the left, and Fox strides through his place. And when he opens the door, there's still a little stank in there.
Oh. Maybe open a window or something, huh?
Yeah. Why is there an oil painting of yourself above the bed? That's something interesting.
People can see it.
It's very generous too. Wow.
Yeah, really. It's just from the waist down, which is very odd.
Like zoomed in.
I wish I could say I didn't recognize him, but I do.
Ruthie.
But hey, guys, the bulge in the painting is 3D.
Yeah. Oh, wow.
Amazing.
Yeah. Here you go. You want to touch it? Yeah, here you go.
It's Trump Loy. It's...
Thank you.
It's a pop-up painting. Okay. I'd like to investigate the bed.
Investigate, yeah. So if everyone wants to roll an investigation check, I imagine that's what you're looking
at. Yeah, we're all going to investigate.
I'm a plus five. Come on, baby.
Oh, gosh.
Okay. Fox, you can do this too. I imagine you've already done this and it helps to have a fresh set of eyes, but you probably want to.
What'd you get, Robin or Clara?
Three.
Oh.
Oh, no.
It's okay. It's not important. Your
bonus?
I have a minus one.
So do I.
Oh, I love you.
That makes so much sense.
Okay, so did anyone get a 15 or higher?
Yes, I got 15.
I got a 19.
Ooh. 15 and 19? Okay, awesome. Oh, nice. Yeah, and Fox, did you roll as well?
I did. I only got a 10.
Okay, sweet. So, yeah, you're kind of...
I mean, in a way, I rolled two ones.
The Fox is a little bit distraught by coming in this room, and this is where it all took place, and his pride is a little shamed, so he actually leaves and goes to make everybody a pot of tea. Would you do that?
Aww.
Would you do something that nice? Probably not. Maybe you just go moke somewhere
or like cocktails.
He's gonna go so Fox goes and sits down to do a bit of journaling.
Right. Awesome. And he does, yeah, maybe you do it. Yeah, you do it on your bed so you can look at yourself too. And
he's so sensitive
during the investigation. But Blades, the one thing you notice is that what he omitted to tell you is that these two ladies entered through the window in the bedroom, and Zabu, you actually when Blades points this out, you look outside and you see a scrap of paper that's kind of caught in the windowsill. And when you look at that.
Sorry, it skipped out on me. Did you say it's...
Oh, sorry.
Did I find?
Yeah, there's a scrap of paper caught in the windowsill. And I think you're obviously doing this from the comfort of Ruthie's arms. But she like... She holds you when Blades points out, you're like, take me to the window, and Ruthie holds you out and says, look around, little guy. And you're able to see the scrap of paper.
Ooh, ooh, ooh. I reach out for it, my hand falls off. Damn it. So then I just reach with my teeth.
Got it.
Pull it out. Oh, Ruthie takes it for me.
Oh boy.
Let's read what's on the scrap of paper.
Okay, so it's half and half, but it does seem to be an advertisement. And the words that you can make out are one night stand ? Find yourself, and most importantly, the name of Seek Waff Spa.
Seek Waff Spa. Seek Waff Spa.
Is that like an anagram or something?
Spa. Yeah, can you spell it?
Yeah.
Because I have a hard time reading these runes.
S-E-K-W-A-F.
Because your eye fell out, that's why.
Right.
S-E-K-W-A-F. Seek Waff. Is that like a language that we know? Can I?
Duo. It's just, it seems to be, it's not a different language. No, it doesn't okay. mean a word in anything.
Isn't
it
that an anagram of Fox's name?
Oh, damn.
To figure that out.
Wow. That's
got the big brain.
That's why they pay me the big bucks, guys.
He had an idea. This is like,
he definitely has higher than an AA.
I have a little gold star in my pocket and I put it on his little chest.
Yeah, thank you.
You're a good boy.
That's so good. That's so great.
I finally got one.
Someday you'll have a dad.
So, oh.
So we have so cruel.
So Fox, hey, so Fox.
Yeah, no, go ahead.
You go. You go.
Yeah, hey,
what's up with this? Oh. Yeah, what's up with this? This slip of paper. Is this from your journal? What is this thing? You found a.
I've never seen this before.
Okay.
Oh. Wait, so this lover of yours was just a one night stand?
Well, in a way.
Wait. I want to do an insight check. What is going on? What is he hiding? Okay. Oh, 19. A 19 plus 5, 24.
Is that okay, right? this will, I'll let you negate or at least challenge if you want to roll a persuasion or deception or whatever you want to
okay,
convince
cool.
them of.
I'm going to roll deception.
I can put a camera on it, I promise.
Oh, no, I only rolled a 12.
A 12. Okay, so still, you're not, well, it depends on what you say, but basically, Codex, you are pretty convinced that he's leaving something out of what he's telling you and perhaps lying to you.
So, Fox, I think that this is not, you are not coming clean with us right now. Either she is a one-night stand or you own a spa. Which is it? Which is it? And I'm going to roll an intimidation
Where is
check.
She?
And if you do own a spa, can you get me like a discounted membership maybe?
I'm doing an intimidation check. I have a negative one, 13.
Okay, so go ahead, Will, and you can roll, just roll a charisma saving throw.
Okay. Wow, that was a whole thing. Oh, nine.
Nine, okay. So you're a little, yeah, you're intimidated by her. She holds the reins of this guild and it might behoove you, if you want to get what you want, to come clean with her.
It started out as a one night stand. Mm. And then it was another night stand and then another one night stand and then another one night stand. And pretty soon we'd had about a fortnight of one night stands.
Fortnight stands.
Yeah. How many?
A fortnight. Totally night stands.
How many?
That's a whole bedroom set.
What is that? Anybody what is a fortnight?
Nobody knows.
We've made many, many coital beds.
Many?
You're dating?
So was she hired? Did you hire her at first? Was she a hired person?
I'm afraid I don't understand what you're getting at.
Did you pay her for sex?
I mean, I'm going to put it like
Fox this. Is aghast. Aghast. As deeply offended. And he says, I never. And he turns around and he storms into the kitchen.
Tink, look what you did. You offended that beautiful man.
I mean, it
man.
Was going to take Codex like 5 minutes to ask the question because she kept trying to beat around the bush about it.
I mean, also, it's like painting is upset at us. The expression changed.
Oh, no.
The bulge follows me no matter where I am in the room.
Yeah, remember, it follows you out of the room.
Okay, so okay. Actually, I'll say any spellcasters, anybody can roll a history check. Just everybody can roll a history check.
Oh,
and my 19. History's negative one, too.
19.
Yeah, plus five on that, too. This is my wheelhouse.
Whoa, I rolled a 18. Natural 20.
Damn, oh, my gosh.
I got four.
That's awesome. That makes a lot of sense too, Tink, because you are the spa queen. Of course you've heard of this spa. You just needed to, find out if he paid for sex first and then it struck in your brain. It was on the tip of your tongue, but you had extra information. Basically, you know that this spa is basically the Medusa's spa and it's in the mountains west of Mondopolis called the Everfreeze Mountains. And yeah, you're... the one night stand, the question mark thing, it's like part of their draw. Like they target sad women.
So they target sad women. Jeez. So what do you know about this?
To the spa.
To the kitchen.
Wait, what? You've been to the spa?
You've been to the spa?
How have you been?
You've probably
been to the spa.
Yes, I've been to the spa. What is the spa called again?
Why are you so sad?
It's called Sequoif.
Sequoif Spa.
I only like going to the spa because it makes me feel better because everybody around me is so sad.
That makes sense.
Hard.
It's a really great place to go to like boost your self-esteem.
Oh, why haven't you told me about it?
Incidentally, that's the same reason Fox likes to go there.
Okay, so hold
on. Don't you think it's a little coincidental that his name is backwards, the backwards version?
It's really weird.
Do you think he owned himself after the spa, or did
no? Because I dated him I dated
what's
him.
What's the chicken and the egg here?
Yeah, Ruthie, what do you think?
I forget. Ruthie, please weigh in on this.
Yeah, go on.
You're right. This ball just following me. I go over there.
Okay, whatever.
Why are we even doing this? Are we going to get? I hate to pull a Vork on us, but like, what do we get out of this?
He said he's going to pay us.
Helping this church.
That's true.
How much?
Listen, he never specified that.
Let's go into the kitchen, negotiate before we like. Waste any more time on this.
He's a member of many societies of pretentious, long-speaking people. Okay, if our reputation can build among those people, eventually we'll get more quests from them, and they hopefully won't go along with us. So, and also, yes. I just need to exercise some really bad romantic juju at the same, you know, like romantic. Energy. Okay, he really dumped
you
me already badly.
Your, his sloppy seconds, if you want.
So if he dumped you so badly, why do you want to help him?
He's so, look at him. He's grown so much. He never would have even.
Oh, honey.
What was that?
Oh.
Wow. Okay. Blades.
I
just want to know what we get out of this thing.
All right, let's negotiate a little bit. You guys take the lead. I have a personal problem here, playing hardball, but we need to go and investigate the spa.
You still love him, don't you?
What? When someone rejects
you horribly.
I think it's more
that she wants him to love her.
You just want to do this because you want his little pee-pee inside of you again.
No, it's not because I threw, it's not like I threw myself at him.
It's not little.
Codex, your butt is sweating again.
It's dripping down the back of my robe.
Betraying. It's wafting. We can all
come on, let's go and tear it.
Okay, let's go into the living room. Let's do it.
Kitchen, he's in the kitchen.
Okay, he's in the kitchen.
Hey, Fox.
Okay.
Oh my God, he has a marble island.
We want to know what we get out of this. So pretty. Out of helping you. You're going to pay us? That was pretty vague. So we're going to help you with this quest. What's our loot?
We need money. We want money.
And so, magic stuff. And also a promise that you'll never kiss Codex again.
Well, that's...
Hey, what?
It's up for debate.
That is not an addendum we needed. No, no.
I would be more specific because people could have sex without kissing, you know?
Really?
So much about you. What?
I'm learning every day.
I mean, he paid for sex. He probably didn't kiss that girl on the first night either.
I thought kissing was sex.
Wow.
All right, Fox.
I do everything but kiss and tell.
You just tell. You don't kiss and tell. Okay.
Of course I'll pay you. Look around you.
Yeah, but all right.
I mean, he does have a marble island.
How much?
It would be
it's
pretty
so
easy
gauche to discuss actual.
Yeah, I think
I'm telling this whole
if you
just
insist,
to get back in Codex's pants.
Okay, we insist. We need to know up front.
It's been insussed.
What we're gonna be and I need an apology for the way you treated me.
Oh,
okay.
God.
I need that too.
That sounds like a separate subject.
No, it's all encompassing.
Okay.
All right. Fox leans over and he takes your hands and he says, I sat on there too.
Your hand fell off.
What? Wait, what?
My remaining hand.
I sat on the bed. I looked at the Rorschach blot. I tried to make it look like a spreading tree. Shadows pooled beneath it, but it didn't. It looked more like a dead cat I once found. The fat, glistening grubs writhing blindly, squirming over each other, frantically tunneling away from the light. But that isn't even the real horror. The horror is this. In the end, it is simply a picture of empty, meaningless blackness.
No idea what you just said.
Okay,
can you realize I'm never talking again?
That was what he told me when I first had sex with him, okay? After that, I literally take my pants off, okay?
That was a good reminder.
Codex, your pants are off!
Okay, oh, I'm sorry. Oh my God, I'm so sorry. And they're drippy too. Oh boy.
Oh, not again.
With sweat.
Be a lady.
Okay, listen, we need 10 gold and just say I'm sorry, each. Okay? But 10 each. Gold each? Each?
Yeah, and then each. We need 10 not for Vork too.
We'll need 10 for Vork. He's on jury duty, but that should be.
And 10 for Clarisel.
And 10 for me.
Ruthie, no, you're just kind of a volunteer here. Come on,
I think Ruthie's going to come in clutch later. You guys watch.
All right, Ruthie, listen, we need, that's a total of 100 gold, okay? Just give us 100 gold and we're fine.
All right.
Okay. Great, let's 100 go.
100 gold.
Well, he's not gold. What?
I hear a condition.
What?
Codex.
Yes?
So Fox leans in really close. And he whispers, I'm sorry.
Oh, there go the pants again.
Codex, your pants.
Oh, sorry. Oh, they fell off again.
It's so wet in other places now.
Oh, stop it. I'm so sorry.
But then he lingers just too long.
Okay. Wow, you smell a little bit like leather now again. This is funny. Okay.
You still smell like cheese.
Okay, and butt sweat. Okay, let's go. Okay, so you guys, I think our terms are good. When I talk to my therapist this week, she's gonna exercise some demons, and this is gonna be great. Okay, thank you, Fox. Yes. That was wonderful. Yeah, okay.
So you've all agreed to Fox's quest, which is to rescue Aristara from the Medusa, apparently, because he finally slept with someone that he fell in love with, and will do anything to rescue her. So you head to the Evenfreeze Mountains, which is a treacherous journey, but you're up for the task. Mm-hmm. And as you make your way up the treacherous slopes, you do see your target. It's a huge stone-tiered pagoda perched precariously on top of a tall mountain peak. And braziers mark the rest of your journey, but at the moment, most of them are snuffed out. And everyone, actually, you don't even need to roll a perception check. You see coming down the mountain, you guys are about a mile away. You can still see it up there, but you see coming down the mountain a figure, a pretty hefty figure stumbling down towards you.
I'm gonna roll a perception check.
Taller than any of you. Yeah, go ahead.
Oh my God, I'm rolling so good tonight. 16 plus. Ooh, 19.
19. Oh. Amazing. Yeah, you can pretty much tell this is a bald Goliath. And she does look female, but and you know that Goliaths are like hardened against mountain weather and cold. But she still is wearing very, very scrappy leathers and like a loincloth kind of getup. But she's kind of stumbling towards you.
Fox. Do you recognize her? Is that one of the ladies that took your lover?
That it is not what it's definitely, even though they're hulking people who took your lover, they were not Goliaths, Fox.
Oh, they're not Goliaths. Oh, they were okay. Do we know what they were? Do we know what
they were big, beefy. They could have been half orcs or big humans. It was something like
large and humanoid.
Caveman, very Neanderthal looking women.
Is there any way to hide from it?
But I will. But since you asked Fox, Zabu, Fox, will you roll a history check just to see if you have seen this person before?
Sure. I have never seen this person before. It's likely I've never seen a where is it? I rolled an 8. I suspect that it's likely I've never actually seen a person in my life. I wouldn't know what a person was if I fell in love with them.
So do any of you approach them, or are you attacking them? Or
does the Goliath appear to already see us, or are they just like patrolling, it looks like?
Oh, good question. Yeah, Codex, you saw stumbling. It did not look official in any sense. So it looked shambling and stumbling, and definitely down the mountain away from the pagoda.
Okay. I don't see why we have to fight her. Let's just see.
Well, she looks wounded. Let's go see if we can help them. Yeah.
Ho there, Goliath.
Ho!
Baby.
Excuse me.
Oh my god, I feel like I've seen her at the spot. Are you okay? Before.
Hello, are you
okay? Oh my god, actually, Amy. Yeah, Tink, roll a history check.
Oh, shit.
Hey, don't have very good memory. Tink, does her sadness look familiar to you?
Yeah, it was that sad, sad eye.
I can feel my self-esteem going up.
Ugh. My D&D, wow, I literally, what? Wait, it kind of glitched, hold on.
Sure it did.
No, it did. It
the like, analog physical die glitch.
Yeah, can I roll again?
Okay. I'm rolling my real dice now. 10.
Mm. And okay,
you know the bonus?
She definitely looks sad, but maybe you glom all the sad women together. So I don't know. It's hard to tell.
Oh, come on.
You know the history bonus?
If you had to guess, you've never seen her before.
Oh, come on.
Well, ma'am, are you okay? Yeah. You look like you might need some healing. Are you okay?
I'm so sorry for my existence. Why would anyone have a conversation with me? I don't know what's going on in the music
industry. Ma'am, it's okay. What happened in there?
Hey, you have value, inherent value.
I've got to figure out what my thing is. I don't know what my branding is. What's my brand? I don't know.
Oh, no.
Okay, you don't have to know that right now. What's happening? What's wrong with you?
Are you my inner monologue come to life? What are you?
I ate too many pickles and everything stinks that comes out of my orifices.
That does happen. Mm.
Okay. Yep. Okay, that's temporary, probably.
Why did you leave the spa? Are you a resident of the spa, or are we visiting? What's going on?
I don't remember. I don't know who I am. But I need to figure it out because I need abs.
You need abs?
Don't we
all? Like the muscles.
Okay,
can we do anything for her?
I don't know. I'm gonna do an arcana check to see if she's unsorcelled somehow.
Yes, it's unsorcelled. Okay.
Can I help with that? I have a plus +5 on arcana.
Oh, sure. I rolled an 11 plus +1. 12? So if
you're 22.
No.
Oh, wow.
22. Okay. Yeah. Wow. Actually, you don't feel any magic going on right now, but Zabu, you actually feel remnants of past magic that seem to be fading from her. So it does seem that at one time she was
definitely
no longer.
She's definitely enchanted and sorceled, whatever that word is, for sure, at some point. Like a little while ago, for sure. Yeah, it wasn't just the pickles. There's something else going on here.
Yeah,
something terrible happened in that spa.
In the spa.
Yeah, what happened
to
you?
That's what I'm guessing.
What kind of spa is this?
What does she have? Does she have any possessions on her, or is she just wearing a loincloth?
It's just her clothes that you can see. She does have some furs like strapped around her arms and her legs and shins to maybe provide some armor or some warmth against the cold. But nothing really on her.
Does she appear to be physically wounded at all, or just like emotionally distressed?
Not physically wounded. No, just emotionally and mentally ensorcelled or incapacitated, I guess.
Okay, here's what I want to do. Here's what I want to do. I want to do a minor illusion and give her abs and see how she responds.
Awesome. Yeah, because she does, her loincloth is just like this strap and then there's a
minor illusion.
A midriff shirt. Okay, great.
Always
so
that's nice.
So she's not really looking at herself right now. She's looking at all of you. Are you pointing it out to her?
Yeah, Fox goes, nice abs.
Mm-hmm. Those, it's some washboard business.
I don't need anyone making fun of me right now.
No.
Look for yourself.
Stop making fun of you.
Does anybody have like a reflecting glass or something to... Oh, wait, I guess you can just look down.
You can look down.
Zabu, just because you your neck your doesn't work anymore.
You can see your abs. You know, yeah.
I'm falling apart here.
On a good day, you can see your abs.
I look like someone now. I'm a real person. I did it. I'm a real person. Okay, now the next step is to make my face pretty.
You are beautiful just the way you are.
Yeah, you're gorgeous. You know what?
Blades will make out with you to prove that.
Yeah.
I don't want Blades. I want a very specific person.
Oh, who do you want?
Such as
you
want?
I want. I can't remember the name, but I'll know him when I hear his name.
Is it Estrella?
Fox.
Is it Estrella? What's your girlfriend's name again?
It's Fox.
It's Fox. You don't say.
Yeah.
He's single.
Wow.
I need Fox.
Oh, he's right here, and he's willing and able.
Wait, you need Fox?
You need to make out with him.
He must love me as much as I love him. I love him so much. I need him. Where is he?
Fox, is this your
girlfriend? If only my breath didn't smell like pickles, I'd be worthy of him.
What is going on here? Hey, guess what? Listen, Fox, what is going on here? Did you cast a spell on this woman so that she would be in love with you?
I mean, I can't be held responsible for every spell I cast.
What?
Wow.
That is so not cool, man.
That is thaumaturgical roofying.
She needs plastic surgery.
Why does she think she needs plastic surgery to get you? Wait, I'm doing an arcana check. What would have been done to this woman?
Is this spa like your harem or something?
13.
Old?
13, again with arcana, like there, I mean, here's what I'll say. I definitely think, I mean, Fox, this is not unprecedented. Women go nuts for you for sure. But magic, like you've never needed to pay for sex and you've never needed magic to make people attracted to you. So these ramblings actually sound pretty much like madness to you. And the fact that she's definitely not even looking at you. They're presenting you like, this is Fox. And she's not reacting.
Oh, so somebody else did this spell. Somebody else did the spell and made people attracted to Fox, but he doesn't know about it.
But they can't see him. She can't even see him, right?
She can't even look. Hey, look.
Hey, look at Fox.
Man, look at Fox. He's right here. Fox is right here.
I see who you're pointing to, but that's not Fox. Fox would never even dare. He wouldn't come into my presence. I'm nobody. He doesn't want me.
Fox got some daddy issues, huh?
Wow.
Say something to her.
Fox, what do you feel about this? Yeah. This is very very upsetting.
Fox looks right at her and says, I think we should all go inside to talk.
Oh, what?
No, I'm not going back there!
And she bolts off. And she bolts off down the
Fox, what the F is going on?
What is going on here, Fox?
Well, that was a ridiculous thing that we don't ever have to talk about again.
No,
we're not going to talk about it.
Somebody is using magic to make women not only feel bad about themselves, but be attracted to you. Okay,
well, like, I bet that's what he did to his one night stand.
Is that what you did to her?
I mean, one tends to follow the other.
What? What?
Well, but to be clear, though, they're like attracted to you, but also don't feel worthy of being in your presence
or seeing you. This is very confusing.
I mean, exactly the same way you all feel, I would presume.
Not me, but
let's go inside. It's going nowhere.
I'm still confused. Let's just go in this. Just go inside. What is going on?
100 okay, gold pieces, perfect. Whatever.
I need a man.
Get out of here.
You let the Goliath run down the mountain, and then you near the tiered stone building that's very pagoda-like and intricate. And as you near the building, the fires of the braziers burn more regularly to light your way and welcome you. And the tower is intimidatingly impressive, but it somehow still looks warm and inviting, just like a spa. It looks warm inside. You can see smoke and steam coming from different chimneys at different parts of the tower. And you do see the sign of Sekwuf Spa and Relaxation Temple. The insignia on the spa happens to be a one head with three snakes coming out of her head.
Oh, Medusa. We have a Medusa spa. Now, do we know about Medusa magic? Could the Medusa be the one who's doing all this magic to get...
You know that Medusa, like, you know as much as you would probably know anyway, which is Medusas have snake hair. And yeah. they can turn people to stone by looking at them. Beyond that, a lot of people, you know that a lot of people go to Medusas to seek everlasting youth or everlasting life or things that are more deity centric. And normally their pride is what gets them killed. You know, that they...
If you guys have never gotten a hot turn to stone massage before? Oh, so good.
I don't think Fox did this spell, you guys, because if he did, he was doing it to insult her women to love him, which would be repugnant. But why would they not recognize him? So this is some kind of errant magic gone wrong, or someone's trying to get back at Fox. Something's happening here that
jealous ex.
Nobody knows what's going on. Yeah, a jealous
ex. I don't like the guy, but he's at least a 7.5.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
So he doesn't need to probably do.
Okay.
If Fox slept with one of the Medusa, I swear to God.
About it. He like is weirdly avoiding it. So he's probably doing something really weird.
Yeah, I don't know.
You guys, by the way, we're talking about him and he's right
here. He's standing right here.
He's like, so.
Okay.
But he's also journaling, so it's fine.
It's true. Listen, he doesn't care about anybody but himself. I know this firsthand. So
I actually peeked at one of the pages and he just wrote me over. It was like,
he has beautiful penmanship though.
We're in danger.
And just hearts around it.
I think that something, I think he did something to trigger something to happen. And that's what's happening. And it's inadvertent.
Wait, you mean he did something to trigger something and then that made something happen? That's crazy. How'd you figure that out? That's amazing.
Oh, Codex is hot on the case.
It's solved. Case solved.
I mean, done now, right?
Listen, she's a graduate. And that's how. All right, let's get into the spa.
Is there anybody in here?
I think we have to go undercover and get some spa treatments. You know what I'm saying?
Yes, for sure. Okay,
What are our identities? Okay.
You enter and you walk through these red velvet curtains and they just feel so soft to the touch, but you walk through them and there is a greeting desk and a human woman stands behind there and she goes, welcome travelers, Scumdonian Northwesterton at your service. So glad to see such lovely women. And men. Oh.
Well, we all want to feel beautiful sometimes.
We all feel sad about ourselves inside. And one's a zombie, so yeah.
And yes, this guy needs it.
Yes, well, welcome to any of them. It's just that if you've ever heard Dana talk, she just reaches into the female spirit. But I'm sure you'll find something quite lovely to listen to as well.
Dana? Dana is the owner of the spa? The Medusa?
Dana, the owner. She is the spa, if you know what I mean. She's everything. She is my queen. We are all Dana. She is all us. It's delightful what she's done for the female community.
Well, I can't wait to get in touch with my femininity.
Yeah, and so this guy Fox is going to pay for us to get full service treatment. Yeah. So.
What we'd like to do, though, we'd like to know where Dana is. Just put it on his tab. Put Fox. Fox.
He's going to pay for
it. Fox.
Yeah, he'll pay.
Wait, she's acting weird.
Gentleman.
Wait. I'm going to do a roll of insight and to see why is she acting like such a weirdo when we say the word Fox. 19. 16 again. Oh. I swear to God, it's my birthday.
Oh my God, Codex.
I'm not kidding.
I mean,
it's
a 24. A 24. I promise.
You have a degree. I believe you.
Yeah, when you say Fox, yeah, you can definitely tell there's a lot more blinking and a lot more eyes wide and swallowing and gulping, and she's pretty lost for words when Fox is mentioned. There's no real way to know why, but it's not, you know, that it's not in the same way that Goliath Lady was reacting. Like she's not rambling or anything. She seems to be clear of mind.
Ma'am.
She's been fanned out.
Ma'am, it seems like the name Fox is familiar to you. Do you know this man?
Knew him? I don't know him. I have heard of him. I have orders.
What are your orders?
Orders?
Yeah.
What are your orders?
Fox, 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 Fox,
Fox. I've been waiting for this day for so long. I can't believe it's happened. It wasn't meant to happen. I don't think this soon, but here you are. You are Fox, are you not? Of course you are. Look at that visage. Look at the jawline.
Fox just stands there, you know, kind of douchily handsome.
Oh, douchey
person. Captain Morganing it.
He's like, yeah, it's Captain Morganing.
Yeah. Totally. Totally.
Look at your weird so bobbing gross. Head and your faux snicker as you cackle off to the side as if you don't know I'm talking about you.
He's a beautiful man.
So what are your orders?
What are your orders?
It's time. We must prepare.
Time for what? What's about to happen?
What is this?
What's happening?
Oh, stop clapping.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Come this way, everyone. And she bounces. She's wearing like basically a really sleek shift of a dress with an apron, but she seems sprightly despite the constricting clothing, and she parts through the curtains behind her, and you are welcomed into, Amy, you've been here before, this incredible spa. Steam pools, about six steam pools greet you, three on each side, and a waterfall at the very back. And everything's made of stone, but it feels like really clean stone, and some of it's even like limestone. Different animals are carved into columns. And she says, "We must bathe! We must bathe for the ceremony! I'm so excited!"
What ceremony? Are we in danger?
What ceremony?
No, you are special guests. Why? Your Fox's wedding party.
Wedding party?
Huh?
Wedding party?
I think
Dibs on best man. I called it.
Wait, Fox, what is going on? Are you aware of any of this,
Codex,
Fox?
Are you okay? Your butt is sweating again.
I don't know. I just, who's going to be the bride? Who's going to be the bride? I'm soaking down there.
Dina, of course. It's Dina. It always was Dina. She was waiting for this whole time. And now he's come to her, crawling to her on his knees.
So Dana stole your Fortnite stand because she was jealous.
Were you cheating on Dana?
Fox, you got to tell us right now. Everybody get naked in the green tea pool, and we gotta have this
everybody
out.
Everybody get naked.
Done.
In the green
tea pool. Don't tell me twice.
I don't know if zombies can go in water, though. That's kind of.
Well, we're about to find out.
This tree now. That's Rufy, the end of
my. You just look like an Alka-Seltzer when you touch the water.
Oh, no.
All of my old armor and clothing is just tear away, so it just comes right off.
Well, he's got tearaway leathers. Wow, Blaze. Why would you have tearaway leathers?
It's all just gone, bro.
Like this.
Except for the pauldrons. They're still
okay. So we're all naked in the hot tub.
Yeah.
And Zabu, there's a couple of toenails floating, but it's cool.
Yeah. I'm so Fox. Sorry. I'm trying to. It's like eating a sandwich inside the hot tub.
Well, Ruthie's got a sieve, and she's just.
Oh, Ruthie's here too. I forgot.
Oh, thank you, Ruthie.
Holding him up.
Dropped by.
Ruthie's what keeps.
I'm gonna fire Timothy Chalamet and keep.
Yeah, Ruthie's way much better. Well, you do have Zabu, to feed Ruthie.
Zabu, I think you need this part back. I know you're in the pool. It's fine, but here.
Is it my left nut or right nut?
Man, I did not look close enough to find out.
Okay. It's lefty.
Fox. What kind of affair did you have with Dana? And what is she doing to other women because you spurned her in some terrible way?
You would remember having sex with a Medusa. You never hooked up with her.
I honestly don't know.
Lies.
You never met a Medusa? You would remember a Medusa. They can't hide their hair. I mean, they're snake heads.
You can't go soft with a Medusa. Sorry.
That's what I hear.
Really? Wow. For the kids.
For the kids. For the kids. Fox, you need to, okay, that's it. I'm going to intimidate you. You better tell us what you're hiding right now.
That's the one.
-1 to my intimidation roll. 17 minus what? 16.
I have intimidation.
Ow. Oh, yeah. Try some intimidation, Clara.
All right. I'm doing it.
We're naked, and this is more intimidating because you're vulnerable.
It was 14.
What do you say, Clara?
I just want to know. You tell us the truth here. We are all naked in some sort of pool, and I want some answers. Enough.
That's like a string of F-bombs. 12. Clara. That's the meanest.
And also,
that
she's standing full naked on the edge of the pool. Like, she is like muff, you know, she's
just
you're
dripping
just like
and mighty.
She's yeah. like,
you tell us.
There's one leg up on the side.
Yeah, that looks like her breasts are flexing at you.
Yeah, you fail whatever you were gonna not be intimidated by Will, and Fox is 100% intimidated.
Okay, so I promise I'm telling you the truth. I'm here for Astara and nothing else. I don't know who Dana is. I've never made a coital bed with a Medusa. That's the sort of thing you tend not to forget. And I just want to stay on task here. Let's stay focused. Let's find my lady love.
Well, it kind of sounds like you're about to get married.
Find your lady love.
I think it's, Fox, that you're about to get married to Dina right now. This is what's about to happen.
Yes,
oh,
that's
no,
right.
That's not happening.
Are you sure? Because that's what this woman, ma'am, what's your name? I'm sorry.
Scondunian Northwest Utility Service.
What?
We're never going to remember that. Can you have a nickname?
Scondi.
Scondi.
Scondi. Okay, Scondi.
Nice. That's pretty.
Scondi, I don't think that our friend has ever met Dana, so it's
No, he hasn't. She built... you don't even know the lore of this place. She built this entire thing to lure him to her because, oh, she's a Medusa, and as beautiful as she is on the inside, she knew that he would never come to her on his own volition.
Wait.
That's kind of a bummer.
Wait, Fox, have you been to the spa? Have you been to the spa as a participant?
No, we would never let him leave if he had been here before.
Okay, can I have a quick huddle with my team?
This
side of the pool.
Get close. Get your naked bodies over. Yeah, Fox, get over.
It's too close. In the green tea pool. I mean, we're already in a bit of a huddle.
No, I'm just saying I want to get Scondi away from us.
Scondi, can you give us a second, okay?
Oh, I'll bring you some. You know what I'll bring you? Some jackfruit tea. Bye.
Jackfruit tea. Okay.
Jackfruit tea is really good.
That sounds delicious. That's great.
Fantastic. We'll get the jackfruit tea. So I think a couple of us have to break off and maybe try to see if we can figure out where Astara is while they're distracted with whatever's going on with this Fox wedding.
Yeah.
Because that's clearly happening now.
Yeah.
And so some of us have to go off and try to figure out where they're keeping Astara or whether she's still alive or whatever.
It sounds like a plan.
We could all just leave and like sneak in. Like, I'm afraid, I mean, are they keeping us hostage? Nobody's like stopping us.
Can't you like form shift or something?
Oh yeah, no.
You should pretend to be Fox and get married to Dana.
Oh.
I can disguise self.
Oh my God.
Oh yeah.
And then kill her at the altar.
Okay. It's on the table.
Let's figure out what's going on because I still think
that
Fox.
Yeah. We were in the axis of anarchy.
I just think we got to figure out if they still have a stair. Yeah, totally. We just got to figure out if they have a stair at all here.
I feel like Fox is still hiding something from us, okay? And so,
really?
He's in the huddle, though.
We've like checked it like 17 times.
Codex just wants Fox to admit that he's still in love with her or something. Okay, she's like really digging Codex, for something.
He did apologize. I think we need to move on.
Okay, I'm sorry.
I mean Fox, that in the nicest way.
We're in a very close hot tub, and I'm trying to have a private conversation with everybody, okay, about you. So just move back.
I've literally been here the entire time.
Okay, yes. All right. Yeah.
Hey, okay, I'd gotta say sorry for turning the jets on.
It's okay. I like the suds, Ruthie.
Ruthie,
come on.
That you're here.
Oh, Ruthie. All right. So, okay. I say that me and Tink should go because I can be a sad person because I fit in here great. So, me and Tink will go explore and see if we can find anybody being held captive. Okay. And then Fox and Fox, you guys turn yourself into Fox so they'll have to figure out which one is you. And that'll be like a whole tongue twister.
Switcheroo.
Oh, too early for that?
Wait, is the wedding? We just got here.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, let's split up and like search for Astara, okay? What does she look
like? Okay, let's do that. Let's split up and search for Astara.
Okay, let's search for Astara.
We'll split up in half.
Okay, in half. Taking
Fox.
All right, I'll go with Fox in case I do have to do the double thing. So,
okay, great. I'll go with Codex.
Okay,
and then we'll take Clara.
Okay, Clara, you're with Fox.
Okay, I'll go with Fox. I need the dice balance.
Okay, right, so what are the two? What are the two groups?
Me, so Tink, Clara and Blades.
Fox, and Clara, okay. Fox, and Zabu.
Clara, Fox, and Zabu. Oh, okay, great. Okay, awesome. So the plan is the Real Fox, what is your team's goal?
I think
Fake Fox, what is your team's goal?
Well, no, I think they're so. Oh,
Real
sorry.
And Fake
I was
Fox
say
are on
that,
the same team.
Oh,
I think our Fox will.
Got
see,
it. Got
see
it. Okay. Okay.
I think we should just go ahead and try to meet Dana.
Gotcha.
See what's okay, up so with that, and then while they go and sneak off and try to find a stair.
Oh, that's not a bad idea.
That's a good idea. Actually, that's a good idea.
I
wow,
get
for
it.
Somebody okay. whose brains are rotting, you're real small yeah. here.
Okay. I haven't eaten my own brains. So.
Okay, good. Yeah.
So are you guys, is the sneaky group trying to leave before Scondi gets back?
Yes, we're going right now.
Yeah,
we're going right now. Okay.
We're just chill. So, we're going to stay.
Yeah, well, I mean, I think we should have some tea first, and then we'll...
Well,
yeah,
we're not going to wait for the jackfruit. We got to get out of here. Clara,
you guys get out of here.
Oh, you're staying here. Okay, you stay here and have the jackfruit. Okay, bye.
Okay, cool. Man. So you see that she left through the back of the room behind the waterfall. That seems to be a way out, but there also doesn't seem to be heavily staffed, and you might get out through the way you came in as well.
Okay, let's do that.
Okay, cool. So you'll head back to the front of the spa, and the other group is going to stay seated. So when Scondi gets back, she notices, does your wedding party not agree with the wedding? Or are they getting, where are they?
Yes, they have some religious differences with the formalities of the wedding. It's,
they needed a minute.
It's, yeah, so.
Oh, they just had to.
They needed to find the little girl's room, is to be honest.
They don't approve of you marrying a Medusa, do they?
They're very, yeah, they're so...
They're not as progressive as we are.
Oh, good riddance! We don't need them!
They show
all
their
we need
colors.
All we need is you. Wait, are you looking like Fox just yet?
Not yet.
Okay, all we need is you, my precious! Okay, so come with me, we'll get you all dressed up for the wedding, okay? We've got suits and dresses for a plenty. You'll be lavishly dressed for the occasion.
I obviously need to bring my friends for support and to celebrate the glorious occasion.
Yeah. Yes, Dana will be surrounded by her friends, and you'll be surrounded by your friends. Let's do this. And if you're willing, she takes you back behind the curtain as well. And now they're just kind of disappeared from the first group's sight.
All right? Okay, great.
Okay.
First group, you're back in the front room. There's a desk there that seems to be stacked with Scondi's notes and kind of the entrance book. Anything you might want to sift through there. Again, yeah, there's not much entrance and exits at this moment. I mean, it's the winter, so not many people are attending. But then there's another door to the right. You, on my map, you went left into the spa, and then there's another doorway to the right.
Okay, and for the record, we're in robes to look like we're spa attendants, but we have our weapons.
Perfect.
For the record.
For the record, yeah.
Great.
So, can I
go through the papers and stuff on the desk?
Mm-hmm. And I'm going to search any drawers. I'm going to search the drawers.
Yeah, searching drawers. Are y'all looking for anything specific?
Anything with her name on it, with his girlfriend's name on it, or that indicates that she may have come through here.
Okay.
Can I go look in the other door? Because they never let me in that door, and I'm really curious.
Oh, yeah, sure. Go ahead. So you, first of all, the people who are searching through the desk, there's nothing with the name Aristara on it, but there is a book. There's like a big fat guidebook that's like really hefty that says Fox's arrival. And it's kind of it's a detailed process of what should happen when Fox arrives. As far as Aristara, there's nothing, but there are a bunch of women signed in the guidebook in the guest book. And as you go through, some of them are crossed out and some of them are erased for as the days go on. And then you actually see, if you're searching hard, you see Tinkerbala's name and hers is crossed out, not erased. And as you continue, you get closer to present day, there are some names that aren't crossed out or erased.
Okay. So some people are
erased.
Yeah, some people are maybe not leaving.
Or they are taken care of. Now, what is the thing about Fox? Does anyone die in this procedure for Fox's wedding and arrival?
Let's go through the guidebook here a bit.
Yeah, you don't have much time, but to skim it, it doesn't look like anyone's dying necessarily, but it is, it's very much like Dana's orders. It's almost cultish how she's chosen Fox as her companion to lead this spa and this retreat of womanhood.
These guys were ready for this.
This whole thing is about Fox. He's probably.
Yeah. It seems to have, she seems to have started about 30 years ago.
Oh my God.
Ago? Wait, that's very,
how old is Fox?
How old was he?
Yeah, wow.
My Six? God, when was he?
Like 5 years old, yeah.
They don't remember.
I mean, he's like, he was like a child, I think. I don't know. I never really
None of us are quite sure how old he is.
I don't know. Can I do a check to see how old he would have been when these plans started? Was this
Yes, he was a junior. He was in your year. Yeah,
he went to school together.
He would have been 5 or 6.
Yeah, that's what I was saying.
Maybe he's a child. Yeah.
He would have been a child, you guys. She's been fixated on him since he's a child. Listen, I did look through his wallet when he was sleeping one night, okay? That's not weird. That's fair. Okay.
I'm with you.
So this whole thing has been built up. The name is his name, and the name of the spa is his name. Like, this whole thing has been to lure him to this day, to entrap him. And she's somehow mind wiping other women to be obsessed with Fox, but like not be good enough. Well, what do you guys think about that? I mean,
it sounds to me like she's trying to poison the mind of every other woman she can get a hold of to not go after Fox so she can have him all for herself.
Oh, yeah, that was succinct.
Wait, when did you grow a brain? This is insane. Guys. You're on fire.
What can I say?
Really? This is incredible.
This is, I don't know how to handle this.
I know, you're putting...
These green tea baths do something to you, you know?
So, Tink, when you go to the room to the right, what you see is this long corridor with some doors to the right and left, about 3, and then some stairs that go up. And this seems to be a way up the tiered pagoda. It seems to be the pagoda itself is seems to have 4 tiers, 4 stories to it. And then there is, Tink, just so you know, there is a directory by the stairs.
I look at the directory.
Yeah, it basically just says first floor spa, second floor bedrooms, third floor courtyard, and fourth floor Dana.
Okay. We gotta go to the fourth
floor.
We gotta go to the fourth floor.
Okay, guys, what are you doing in here, Tink? We're going to the fourth floor? What?
Yeah, it says Dana. It's just Dana.
Why would you put your name on the directory? That's
the third floor is a weird choice for the courtyard.
No, you are these underground? The first two are underground floors. Wait, wait, to be clear, is the courtyard like a ground level or is this underground?
It says courtyard.
We got to go up to Dana's office.
I'm not going to explain it before you see it. Yeah.
Okay, let's go up to Dana's office.
But we're going to stop at the third floor and see what that's about.
Or do we go to the bedrooms and see if the girlfriend is there? Because why would...
Yeah.
Let's go to the bedrooms.
Yeah, that's our mission.
This is fourth floor, Dana. Aren't you curious? Let's just start from the top and then work our way down.
That's the whole point, though.
No, they're Clara. Yeah,
our mission is the girlfriend.
The girlfriend. We gotta go see the girlfriend. They're going to see Dana. Okay, we gotta get this girlfriend before we get to Dana. Right, they're going.
All I care about is the courtyard.
Okay, fine.
Listen, I'm curious too. Okay, I'm curious.
You're curious.
Oh God, stop. I have a
it's
list.
How
okay?
Jed you would speak.
Just can I just cut back to us for a second? Hey guys, I'm sure our partners are just doing great. Yeah. Over. I have so much faith in them.
Yeah. I think they're doing really
as you're sipping fucking jackfruit tea.
So...
I am getting a little pruny. Oh no, we're not in the are we?
No, you're not. Where did y'all land? What floor what do you want to explore?
We're going to the bedroom floor. We're going to the bedroom floor.
Second floor. Great. Fine. Okay. So we'll cut away from you guys and we're back to wedding party group. So Ruthie is still carrying you, Zabu, at the moment. And so the four of you are led by Skandi into these quarters that it's basically like a Kardashian closet. And you just have the lay of the land, and she points to anything and is like, whatever you would like to wear to look beautiful for the wedding is up to you. I'll give you 5 minutes to dress and then we must be on our way. And she kind of pops out of the room and stands at the door.
Is there anything?
Would any of this, is there anything in this clothing ensemble that would qualify as heavy armor?
Okay. Yes. There's something, Fox, that you notice that's like, really strange. It's like when you look around, it's stuff you definitely would have chosen for yourself, you know, like she's done her research. But on top of that, there's also things like on like a podium. It's like that one sock that you lost that one time.
She's like Kodak. It's like,
really loves you.
And
wow, I need to take notes.
Yeah.
And it's got the inside joke that you made about it, like the little fairies must want my foot cold or whatever you said there. And it's like, oh wow, that's from my past. Like little, you know, when you're a kid, you figure that your mom threw your toy out. No, it's right here, you know. She's...
Mr. Bungle! Fox runs over and sees just his teddy bear, Mr. Bungle, and he falls down and he's holding it and sobbing into its fur until it's like threadbare old fur is just worn, soaked. Through Mr. Bungle.
That's horrible.
Reunited.
That's sweet.
And, wow. When you start crying, Skandi comes in. Is everything all right? I heard the beloved crying.
Skandi, where did you
hold up Mr. Bungle?
The whole thing.
Skandi, where did you get all this stuff? This is all Fox's old stuff. Where did Dana get this stuff from?
I didn't get it for her. She has people to do that sort of work for her, but I just manage the spa.
Can I see if there's anything reflective to wear? Or you know.
Yeah, let's see. Yeah, there's definitely some, but yeah, nice. There are some larger sequined outfits that you would consider like a mirror.
I'm gonna choose that.
Which okay, PS great. Are gonna look great on you.
Yeah, yeah. You're gonna sparkle and shine.
Yeah.
Like
a diamond.
Like a diamond. And so Will, you're choosing something. Anything that is heavy armor. You actually can. I think I gave you breastplate, so you can go full plate and I think get a +2 to your armor class.
Great.
And but it's white. It's painted like a tuxedo on the front.
Amazing.
Like a white tux. But yeah, you're fully armored, and it's definitely something you would pick out for yourself. And Clara, is there anything in?
Yes.
Clara, is there something that you're drawn to?
Yes. all the, like a nice, I feel like a nice frock would go well with for the ceremony, but then
maybe something floral and like A-line.
A-line.
Yeah, that's definitely there. Yeah. And you, let's see, do you, I can't remember if you have any armor, but let's say, I mean, this is all for Fox, and Fox loves to be in armor, so let's say you find like a floral A-line frock that has a +1 to your armor. Ooh, and Ruthie's gonna slip into like the slinkiest thing you've ever seen, and it rips in all the wrong places, like like love handles poking out,
muffin topping everywhere,
like just her belly button is like in a slit.
My god.
Yeah, she looks like a sight for sore eyes, but you know what, she feels beautiful, so
bless her heart.
Hey, own it.
Okay, cool. So with that, the wedding party's decked out. Scondi comes back in and says, "It's time for the ceremony. Follow me." And we leave the other crew on the second floor in the bedrooms. And at that moment, we will go ahead and take our break.
Yay! We're going to be giving away a Dragonburned Designs box. It's going to be sent to you. Shaka, I can't talk today.
You graduated.
Mama's having vodka. And so we're going to take a little pee-pee break, and we'll be back in 10. So stay here. And thank you for the hype train, you guys. Thanks for supporting us. It's so nice of you. Grab a shirt if you can, and check out Dragonburn's Designs. Thanks for giving away that box. All right, we'll see you in a minute.
Hey, thanks for bearing with us for the break. Where we last left off, our intrepid heroes were splitting the party very wisely. One half was going to explore the rest of the spa house to search for Aristera, and the other one is being led by Scondi to the wedding. And so let's go to those folks first. We've got Scondi leading Zabu, Fox, and Clara, and Ruthie through the pagoda house, and she takes you outside where it's a little bit chilly, and she's very excited. She's like pepping you up, and she hands each of you flowers, and she puts a corsage. Ooh, corsage, hello. On. No, fuck it. She does a garter. She puts a garter on Ruthie. She puts a garter on Ruthie, and she puts a corsage on your breastplate, which is easier to attach a flower to than you think. So she leads you up two flights of stairs. This is basically where the courtyard is, if the other group can remember, but you wouldn't know where that. So she's got this big wooden door, and she says, "No, I'm going to bring you in, and then the festivities will start, and it's really up to Dana. I just have my orders. I'm not sure if this was meant to happen today, but it could happen at any time, I guess, and today's the right time for you." Okay, let's do this. And she swings open the big tall oak doors, and inside you see a basically like a greenhouse, and it does reach up to the sky. For the fourth floor people who are confused, there's a balcony around this courtyard greenhouse thing, but the entire room of this courtyard is made of glass, including the ceiling. And within the courtyard, you see a bunch of statues, and you see the greenhouse has on the top, it has snow on it, but there's no snow on the statues. It's a little warmer than it seems like it should be, but at the very back of the greenhouse, there's a dais, and a banner unfurls that says, "Congratulations, Fox and Dana," and some two spa attendees pull some confetti, and it kind of it and then peters out, and everyone's just kind of confused. And Dana, or sorry, Scandi says, "So there you have it. You are meant to go up to the dais and stand there, and then your wedding procession can be to the side of you, and then Dana will make her appearance when she's ready. I thought she would have known. But I have to go manage the spa. So see you later." And she closes the oak door behind her. The room we're left in is, sorry, go ahead, Zabu.
No, I just want to check if the locked.
Whoa!
Oh God, he's turning. He's turning.
What did you say?
Someone pick his jaw off the ground.
Sorry. Can I freeze for a second? I just wanted to see if the door was locked that she closed behind her.
Okay. Was there anything you wanted to do? Sorry, I did kind of breeze through it. Was there anything you wanted to do while she was kind of doing her showcase and the banner unfurls?
I guess I just wanted to check my exit points or something, just make sure that I can get the hell. I mean, if there's a bunch of statues, I presume that those people were once alive.
Right. Yeah. Clara
have now been statued.
Yep.
Yeah, you would assume that. And Clara, is there anything you'd want to do?
I'm good.
Okay. Ruthie's gonna follow yearly. She's also just enjoying herself. Fox, what about you?
I'm gonna ready my longsword.
Okay. Then yes, as you check exit point, Zabu, you see at the very back in the left-hand corner, behind the dais, there is a round tower, and that there's a round tower with a door that leads to it from the courtyard. Beyond that, it's really these big oak doors, and that's kind of it. It's this courtyard is.
There's a tower. That tower like goes up through the glass, or like where does that thing go?
It's
the balcony.
It's a round cylinder, and it basically it acts as a corner for this glass. So the glass leads up to this tower, but the door opens and it looks like it goes straight up one story. And then the balcony around the courtyard exists as well, but it's a good like 12 feet high, the floor of that balcony. And when you check the door, it does seem, I mean, it doesn't open readily. So locked, sure. It doesn't seem to be magically locked.
I'm just too weak and zombie-ish to open, is what you're saying? Okay.
Ruthie can open it for you.
We don't want to get frozen into statues. So we got to use reflective surfaces if Dana comes around, not look her in the eye kind of a situation.
I don't know.
Any thoughts, ideas?
How is she going to marry Fox without turning him into stone?
I'm just going to need you to say that one more time.
I was just wondering how you guys are going to get married without you turning into stone.
I'm feeling like someone who's been obsessed about me since I was 5 years old and built this entire thing to put all this together is maybe not what you would call a reasonable person.
These stone people, do we recognize them or see a pattern about them? Do they all look similar to Fox? Are they former lovers? Just curious.
Good question. If, I mean, you, unless you know Fox's former lovers, you would.
No, I meant Dana's former lovers.
Oh, Dana's.
I'm just wondering if I notice anything about the statues. Can I do like a perception or a?
Absolutely. Actually, all three of you do a perception. Yes. I guess either investigation or perception. Yeah, it'll be about the statues either way.
I get a +5 on investigation. I'm going to go there. Okay.
You get +5 on everything. What's going on?
No, just investigation arcana. That's what it is.
Okay. It's all he uses.
I rolled a 10, so I imagine I'm very.
That's a natural Will Wheaton 20.
we must honor it.
I didn't realize we were employing the curve. Thank you. Yes.
I got a 16.
I got an 11.
Okay. Clara and Zabu, you both recognize that most of these are humanoid females. They're all different versions of very attractive. And Fox, why did I have you roll? You can pick out just at a glance, you recognize you have slept with at least a handful of these women, and you can't remember if you've slept with the rest of them, but they seem to be figures that maybe you did.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Hey, Fox,
I have sort of a terracotta army of former.
And on that, we'll cut away to the other group. So Blades and Tink and Codex.
So we sneak into the second floor, the bedroom floor.
You're sneaking into the second floor, the bedrooms. Yes. Okay, so you come to this floor and it wraps around the whole building, kind of like a hotel, a little bit of a maze, but the rooms are numbered. And as you're exploring, you do hear, it seems to be rather empty at the moment because the spas are activated or open for business. But there are a few rooms that sound like there are people kind of moving around in them. Probably not many, about three. Yeah.
I'd like to listen at one of the doors. See what I hear. Okay. Grab a glass.
Let's say that
Ruthie gave me this.
Yes, definitely. Oh, perfect. So
whiskey.
So you listen in and you hear someone doing some self-affirmations. It's a female voice and she's going, "I'm worthy. The stories that I told myself when I was 10 years old, they're not true today. I am powerful and I belong." And it's that kind of stuff. And she's just doing some work on herself. That's what you hear. There are a couple of others that you can examine if you'd like to.
I think I'm fulfilled on that. Yeah.
We're going to each examine, we're going to just spread out because we got to hurry, okay?
Yes, okay, awesome. So Tink, you open a door? No, you just listen in, right?
Can I like knock on a door and be like, "Excuse me, your appointment, it's your appointment time."
Okay, and you do that to a room where you hear someone like wailing, sobbing.
Great. You're up next. Knock.
And she opens the door and she says, I don't know if I can do this. I need more. I can't. I'm not good. I'm not. What's this appointment? Are you here to help me?"
Yes, I am here to help you, but I'm sorry.
"Why are you so fucking pretty?"
Thank you. I work a lot on my skin. I work really hard on that. But I need to check you in, so I'm going to need your name, please.
"Oh, yeah, sure. That's fine. I'm Crava Googles."
And then I shut the door on her.
Oh, my God.
Look, it's effective, all right? Okay. Tink gets shit done.
Okay, all right. So now you know Crava Googles is enrolled.
Useless.
Pretty useless. And then Codex,
running into doors. I'm just opening them like, hello. And then I'm transient. And I'm like, "I'm sorry." And if I see one and it's not the person I want, I'll just be like, "Oh, sorry, wrong room." So I'm just like running.
Yeah, none of these.
How do you know what you're looking for, though?
You're asking for
Aristera, right?
Yeah. Or someone who fits that description. Aristera in here. Okay, bye. Aristera in here. Goodbye. Real subtle.
Okay, you actually you don't see Aristera in any of them, but there is a woman, and she goes, "Ah!" And then she looks at you and goes, "Oh my gosh, Codex?"
Oh no.
So she's like, "Oh my gosh, they got you too, huh?"
Wait, what? Do I recognize her?
Vaguely you do. This is someone back from your college days in spell school.
Fox.
Oh my god. Hey.
You and Fox were together.
I'm gonna do the thing that I do in real life that I don't recognize anyone and I don't remember anybody's name. So I'm like, oh my god, it's you. How are you? Oh, it's been so long. You look great. How has you've been doing that thing?
Okay. I'm gonna be real with you. You're in danger.
What are you talking about? Is she wearing is she wearing like an employee outfit or is she wearing?
No, she's got a towel wrapped around her and she looks matter of fact. And she goes, I've been doing the math here and I know why I'm here. It's because of that scoundrel Fox. I slept with him back in 1563. And that was, by the way, that was when you guys were together. And I know they've been on my ass ever since then. I know it. This whole thing is built around Fox this, Fox that. They target these insecure women, which I've gotten way past by now. And they bring you in.
You seem very
here.
Self-confident, actually. You feel very centered. I would like some tips.
Thank you.
Keep going.
Yeah, thank you.
Oh, Tink, this is my friend Tink. Tink, ask her name.
Hi, what is your name?
I'm Akris.
Yeah, Akris. This is my friend Akris from college. She slept with my boyfriend when I was dating with him. Yeah, she's great.
Hi, Akris.
That's like a pretty bitchy move.
Yeah, No, I mean, look, it was college. What are you going to do?
But I know. I slept with everybody's boyfriends. Not. I never did that.
Yeah. Well, if you want to judge me, that's fine. I'm good with it. But my thing... My thing now is to help myself, and I guess since you're here, help you too. She's coming for you.
Who?
Anyone.
Who?
Dana.
Oh, why are you still here then?
I didn't know that's what this was. They told me this was like, I got a free 2-week stay. I was going to do yoga. I was going to do Pilates. I was going to do meditation. I was going to do it all. And they got me here. And then one by one, these people who have these Fox stories disappear.
I know there's life and death stakes here right now, but why didn't I get invited? Why was I not invited here?
Oh, like, let's not open that can of worms now.
Like, really? Like,
no, but you're here.
No,
so
but I'm here.
You were invited.
Well, I mean, Fox came to me. Like, there was no reason. Like, it was just a tangential, like, oh, oopsie daisy.
Did you really
like,
sleep with him?
I mean,
yeah.
Yeah, we're talking. She's talking about me, okay? Yes.
Oh, okay. Well, did you sleep? Oh, okay.
I mean, we did some. It was.
Let's unpack this right now. We have time.
I mean, do we need to talk? Yes. Okay. Yes. I think.
Yeah. I mean, y'all were together. It makes sense. I don't.
It makes sense.
For that.
It makes. Yeah, we were together.
But what I don't understand. You're saying that you weren't lured here.
No, I didn't get a free spa. I never won anything in my life. Ever.
You came here by your own.
No, Fox came to get me to find his other girlfriend. Have you seen an elf, a wood elf named Aristera?
There's layers to this.
Listen, just go with what I'm doing. I'm not going to give you all our backstory. It's too long, and I don't like you that much.
Do you know a girl named Asteria?
Or Asteria. Asteria. Aphrodite. Asteria. I don't know.
Asteria.
What's her name? Asteria?
Her name is Asteria.
Upstairs? Yeah.
Upstairs?
Just cut back to us
She's
real
upstairs?
Fast to be like,
hey. Ambrosia.
I'm sure they're killing it down there.
Her name
I'm sure
is
they remember the name down
the
there.
Day. I think they're going to save the day.
She's a tall wood elf.
Don't worry. They've got it under control.
We're going to be fine. We're going to be fine. Mark in terms of stature.
Tall, bronzed skin.
About. Yeah. Okay.
Upstairs area.
She was upstairs area. She was here.
Yeah. Where is she now?
I don't know. They're like picking us off one by one. It's like. It's strange they haven't gotten me. I feel like I'm the last one of the crew that was recruited.
You feel really casual right now if you think you're going to be murdered and you're just going to tell.
You're so like measured.
It's a
so
real casual approach to death and life.
I'll say, okay, I understand your point, but I've spent the last week and a half doing work.
I believe it.
I mean, if you're going to be given a free 2-week vacation to a spot, go ahead and write it out until the last day. I get
you. Yeah, just use it.
Yeah, I'm like, I'm at peace. I'm calm. I'm not angry. I'm just good with my anger, if that makes sense. And I don't know what I'm going to do. I'm like alone here. And these people are powerful women who she's targeting, you know, like they should be able to defend themselves. I should be able to defend myself. I don't know what to expect.
Okay, well, you can just
Where are they being taken, first of all?
Where are they taken?
It's like up.
See, he told you we should have gone to the fourth floor.
The third floor or the fourth floor?
We're working our way up there.
Let's go to the fourth floor right now. I go like this. I just smack her in the face. Oh, I'm like, how dare you cheat on my boyfriend?
Oh my God, Real Housewives of Mondopolis right here.
With my boyfriend. Okay, that was for college. B and A. I don't know what your name. I forget your. It's fine. Whatever. You're the worst.
Akris.
Yeah.
No, look, I'm proud of you.
That started off great.
Really? You're proud of me?
Yeah. I didn't think you ever had it in you. I mean, I felt like I slept with him right under your nose, and you were just such a pushover. You never did.
No, it's true. Let's go to the fourth floor.
I feel really like, hold on.
Nice to meet you, Akron, whatever your name is. Let's go.
I'm going to hug it out. I really, Akris, thank you for taking that like a woman. Like, I really appreciate it. And this is a wonderful, I feel like I'm blooming inside, and my butt is sweating so hard from hitting you. But right now, yeah, it's just, you're really, you're amazing. Yeah. And I'd love to like catch some coffee with you once we got back to Minneapolis.
You went back to Weak Sauce. Yeah, okay, maybe. But you went back to Weak Sauce. I liked you better when you slapped me. But if you fuck up that bitch, Dana, then I'll be back on board with coffee.
Okay, bye, Akris. I like
this
you.
This request is one just protracted therapy session for Codex, I think.
I like this. I don't have to pay for it next week.
The entire six seasons of the film was.
So y'all go all the way up to the fourth floor, and as you get there, it's the hallway that wraps around the
the roll counts.
It was like my Bluetooth earpiece that fell out.
I
know, sorry, I can't believe you didn't hear it. It's a big hallway that wraps around the courtyard. So you actually see the glass, and you see within the courtyard, you see your friends, you see the banner, you see the statues, and it's really a viewing area, but you do see the tower at the back that heads towards Dana. So you head towards there. We cut back to the courtyard where things are happening.
The wedding party.
The wedding party.
I want to ask a question.
Yeah, what's up?
Hey, Fox, do you see Aristeria in any of these statues?
Oh, good one.
Good one.
Good one.
I see all of them.
Thanks, guys that aren't in the scene.
Fox sort of slowly and deliberately walks amongst them and sort of like touches the cheek of one and touches the shoulder of another and
you can just be giving me tips as well as to how you scored all these women. That'd be really helpful.
I mean, it's commendable. Well, it is commendable.
You start
look at this,
by being
look at this night elf. God, wow, okay. It's tough.
And I do not see her. I do not see her in amongst this fabulous monument to my coital prowess.
He's so humble, isn't he?
Yeah.
And yeah, you don't see them, but as you kind of parade through the aisles of these Westworldian stone figures, you see this huge lever in the middle of the room that's about your height. And what, Sam?
No, go ahead.
Yes? No, it's a huge, it's like, yeah, big, huge lever. And the fulcrum of it is in the floor itself, in the stone floor, and it looks like it moves one, like forward and back. At this moment, you hear a booming voice from the tower that says, "Oh, I'm not ready. I needed at least a week more. I was going to learn everything. I'm not ready." And you hear a click First, you hear like a window slam, then you hear a click, and a booming voice starts counting down from 10.
Oh god.
Oh boy.
10.
Should we pull that lever?
Let's pull that lever.
I think we should pull the lever.
In the courtyard.
I like the lever better.
Lever alone.
Let's do it.
Hey, I just wanted to really quickly say that I think one of these statues is pregnant. Okay, let's pull this lever. Oh my god.
Pull the lever. Okay, pull the lever.
So at 7, you pull the lever. And
hey, wait a minute.
What?
Fox always practices safe sex, and he always gets consent. Because safe sex and consent is sexy.
It's true.
Okay.
That's the message of this, one shot.
Thank you.
It's not the message of this one shot. So when you do, you hear kind of a crackle, and you look to your right, and one of the women shakes back to existence, and she's freed.
Hello, lady.
And my God. That happens when you pull the lever, and sorry, from Texas, y'all. And the voice starts counting down from 10 again.
I was just going to say, pull it again. The lever.
Go ahead. No, I want to hear the also.
Oh, yeah, also.
Also, as the woman shakes back to life, she turns, focuses her sight on Fox, and you see the most vicious rage you've ever seen. This is Foro, and you definitely did sleep with her, and she runs up to you and just starts pounding. So I'm gonna see if she hits.
Oh boy.
Oh wow. No.
Sorry.
Does a 16 hit you?
No.
Ooh.
It doesn't?
No, my fancy armor.
Ooh, your fancy plus two armor?
My fancy plus two armor means that you need a 17 to hit.
Okay, good to know. She misses, but she's beating the living hell out of you. At this point, this group, I'll have roll initiative.
Hey.
Oh my God, you gonna mow down your ex-girlfriends?
They have it. They have this.
I mean.
Oh my God.
I mean.
Oof.
That is a number that I rolled. I told you. I told you.
17. I got a 17 over here.
Oh, nice.
That's 13. Okay. 13 I got.
Okay, so Zabu and then Clara. Awesome. And then we have Fox. Okay, so my God, I think my ear.
Oh no.
Yeah, sorry. Okay, so Zabu, what do you want to do on your turn?
Well, is she under any sort of spell, or is she just like?
Oh, good question. No, she seems to have like fully woken up. She's lucid.
She's just pissed at him.
She's pissed at him. Yeah.
Okay. let's see. Can I just want to shout you like, hey, stop beating up Fox. We're here to help you. We just saved you from imprisonment.
Okay.
Does she have anything?
She says, here's the whole reason I'm here. I did this whole spot thing to get away from him. He infected my mind.
It wasn't him. It was the Medusa that runs the place.
No, it wasn't. He was, how sexy he was. He was so sexy, Fox. And I just couldn't get him out of my mind.
You and your bulge really put us in a predicament here. Oh man. Okay.
Not resort to violence.
I know. I don't want to hurt her.
Yeah.
Can
maybe just like a quick slap in the face. Snap out of it.
Oh, I like that.
Yeah.
So I'll just use
a grip.
You know, no spells or anything. I'll just use my hands, just an armed attack to try to. He's your friend.
In my head,
you're slapping her.
I want Zabu to tell Ruthie to do it, and Ruthie walks up with Zabu.
Yes, perfect. I give Ruthie my hand to go slap her out of
it. Just like a quick little
slap. Oh my
slap.
God. Oh, just okay. Like... So Ruthie's going to be slapping you? Or sorry, Ruthie's going to be slapping the girl?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. With Zabu's hand.
With Zabu's hand.
Zabu's severed hand.
The end of Chinatown.
Kind. Okay, Ruthie's, y'all, Ruthie's a troll.
Oh no.
That was coined by Codex. Ruthie's a dang troll. So she's pretty powerful. Let's see what her melee is.
Oh no, are we gonna kill her? We don't wanna kill her.
She can do non-lethal damage, but she can also, I mean, this is just a woman that Fox slept with. So let's see. I rolled a one.
Oh my god.
No.
So Ruthie takes Ruthie takes your hand and says what you want her to say. It's like, hey, leave her alone, and slaps it. And it just, your hand goes down the back of her shirt. Yeah, so your hand's.
I think I just copped a cheap feel.
Your hand's gone for now. Okay.
I'm sorry.
Clara, what do you want to do?
Well, I just want to like, hey, calm down. Let's get it together, lady. There's no need to.
Okay.
You can like.
Yeah, if you wanna, keep in mind the voice is going down. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. Gosh, okay, so Clara, weird. If you want to roll a persuasion check, I'll let you do that.
Yeah. Oh, that's 14.
Oh. 14. Okay, she does stop attacking and she looks at you and says, "What? What are you talking about?"
I'm just saying, let's not get crazy here. There's counting down. I don't even know what's happening. Just relax, lady. We know he's hot. We get it. All right? Calm down.
He's not hot. He's hot, but he also deserves my wrath.
Well, take a deep breath. There.
I've been trapped here for 2 years. Do you remember 2 years ago, Fox?
I mean, I remember a lot of things, but to know oneself is to.
They're counting down.
Okay,
that's counting down.
So, Fox, it's your turn.
All right. As a standard action, I am going to use divine sense to detect. Good and evil, and it says that this way what I'm hoping to do is sense if she's enthralled, or what was your great word, Felicia?
Ensorcelled.
Enthralled, ensorcelled, or otherwise not in control of her actions.
Okay, cool. So and you just divine sense just does that, right?
It just like, goes off.
It just goes off. Yeah, you. She does not seem to be ensorcelled.
Okay. So Fox says, we have to get out of here. I have to get you out of here. I have to get you all out of here. And Fox runs to the lever and cranks the lever back and forth.
Oh, okay.
That scared me, Blaze.
You just keep going and going and going.
So he does it like 5 times.
Oh, wait. 5 times.
Wow.
For each time that you do it, it starts counting down, and then you do it again. It starts counting down. Do it again. It starts counting down. On the fifth time, basically 5 statues come back to life.
They're gonna be 5 pissed people.
They're 5 pissed women. Coming for you, and it starts counting down again.
Hey, Codex, they're fine down there, right? Like they're
fine. It's fine. We have so much time up here.
I'm just watching this through the glass.
It's fine. Get all of them. I mean, don't leave any statues. Just get them.
So two hit with their fists, and they somehow connect with a piece of armor, a chink in your armor, and the two of them, they do 13 damage to you.
Oh,
I deserve that.
Wow.
Jeez Louise.
But the other three totally miss, and so did the first one. And so they're all yelling at you, how dare you, how dare you? And they all are very much aware that they're in this club of people that you slept with and kind of left to dry. And they're on each other's team now. Back to y'all three up at Dana's room. You're at the door. You also see your friends fighting down in the courtyard one story below.
Wow, Codex, do you want to like get in there?
I mean, how are we going to reason with a bunch of... It's so beautiful to watch.
Oh, yeah, I meant to get some licks in.
I just can't stop. I mean, he deserves it. But you know, you're right. I think we should focus. Listen, Dana's going to come down and want to get married in a second, and we're all going to have to fight her. Or yeah, maybe we can reason with her. Probably not, since she's...
We should go in there now.
Where are we?
We are like looking down on the courtyard, but we're on Dana's level. I think we should go and try to head this thing off at the pass, and they can handle the women. So, right? Let's go to Dana or go downstairs.
Go find Dana.
Let's talk to Dana.
Okay, let's go to Dana.
Okay.
But we can't look her in the eye, remember? Okay, she's a Medusa. Right. It's iffy. Okay, great.
Okay, perfect. So you try to break through this door. The door in front of you to Dana's room is locked.
Mm-hmm.
Is it? Yes.
can I pick that?
Yeah.
Ooh. Oh, I can. Ooh. Can I aid you?
Sure.
Can I help?
Okay. Yes. Yeah. So you can roll with advantage, Blades.
Good, because I need it. Let's see here. Oh. Oh no. Okay. Well, that was a 14 for my lock picking.
But I did that thing. You can add a. Can I aid him with my
guide?
Guidance. That's what I meant.
So you add it. 1d4.
Okay, so 16. 16 will do it. 16 will do it. So, you pull through. The door itself is pretty ornate, and you just kind of and crack it open. What you see inside is definitely a stonework room, but it is lavishly decorated with a bunch of curtains and stuff. And you see, it does appear to be a bedroom. There's no one inside there at the moment. There is a stairway that it looks like a circular stairway that goes down towards the back of the room. But no one is in this room that you can tell at the moment.
Are there any other rooms leading off or just the stairway down?
There's a door to the other side of where the kind of balcony viewing point is of the building.
So the place that we wouldn't know about, it would be downstairs. We need to go downstairs. That would be the area that we can't see what's in.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Yeah, okay. Exactly. Go. I'm running. Okay. I'm running downstairs.
So you're running downstairs. You just run downstairs, and what you see is like a fox shrine.
Ew.
Oh, dear. So
the dressing room where all the foxes, you know, childhood things are. This is to the next level. This is his pictures and drawings of him, both like fan art and actual renderings, things that he's owned, like newspaper clippings.
Oh, honey.
Oh my God, it's a closet of hair, just hair with dates on it. Oh, Jesus Christ.
Some exactly. Straight, some curly. It's bizarre.
Whoa, it's very, very
good a thing.
You see a wood elf in a cage in a corner, and she seems to be weak and asleep. And you do see the back of the Medusa's head. She's basically sitting at this desk, and she's like furiously poring over paperwork and mumbling to herself.
I want to try and quietly creep to the cage.
Okay. Yeah. So for geography's sake, the cage, the Medusa is basically in the center of the room, facing away from the stairwell. She's facing towards the courtyard, basically. Mm-hmm. And then your charge, your Aristera, is to the right of you. Okay. So you are able to do that, or at least try without her actually seeing you. And she is very distracted. So go ahead and roll a sneak check.
Okay. And
Tink and Codex, if you want to join him. Please roll us.
To sneak?
Stealth check, yeah.
Okay, I'm going to do
it. That was a 17 for stealth.
Hell yeah.
Hell yeah.
16.
Hell yeah.
11.
What's the time you roll a number that has Dean in the name?
Do you have... One of these things is
feels good, man.
The other.
Good. I'm happy for you.
Do you? No, you don't have passive. Okay, we're getting you pass without trace when you level up. But okay, so sorry, Codex and Blades, you're able to get to the cage. You probably position yourself in an advantageous position where you wouldn't actually be seen if she looks behind you. But Tink, on your way there, you're kind of just like, I mean, you're curious about the lavishness of this room. And as you're kind of examining like a handcrafted rug that's hanging on the wall, it actually like detaches from the wall and falls down. And the Medusa like jolts up and kind of looks around.
I'm gonna immediately hold person.
Oh my god, no, what? Why?
Because okay. She's looking over at Tink.
Okay.
Oh, I gotta somehow, it lasts 1 minute.
But then she'll know where you are, he said in a hushed tone.
No, she won't. She won't know where the spell came from. We're stealth. She doesn't see us. Okay, I'm gonna hold person. I'm doing it.
So I make a...
You need to make a wisdom saving throw or be paralyzed for a minute.
Okay. Honest roll, 16 plus 1 is 17.
Uh-oh.
So what is your... I don't think you have a spell save DC that high.
I have a plus 5. Oh, that was a saving throw. My spell DC is 13.
13. Okay, so it doesn't quite work. But you do expend your second level spell slot.
Great, that's wonderful.
And she is able to tell where you are.
Great, that's wonderful. Yeah. Great.
Now
I am, however, tucked into the shadows.
Yeah, and even though she looks at you, as long as you're not looking at her, which you would know based on what you know about Medusa's.
Yeah,
you wouldn't necessarily be petrified automatically, even if she does look at you. You have to be, yeah, you would have to look her in the eyes. So let's roll initiative for y'all too.
Oh fair my enough. God. Okay. This is not good.
We're gonna fight the Medusa. Oh no.
I just want to interject something. Back in the old days, we would call this the table talk. I have D&D Beyond over here on this, on my Chromebook. And I just realized that there is a little, polyhedral die, and you can click on it and it rolls a die. That's fun. So I was like, oh, I'll roll that die and see what happens. And I just wasted a crit.
Sounds good. About right for this.
The guys are just taunting you now.
So that's fun.
Okay.
Everything is going according to plan, everybody.
Great.
Oh, your shirt is using up all the crits too.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
Okay.
I got a 7 for initiative.
7?
Okay. A 9.
Oh no.
Yeah.
Ooh, am I rolling 2?
Yeah, Tink, you're rolling.
Oh my god, because I just rolled 21.
Ooh, okay, awesome. Wow. So you actually get to act first, then the Medusa, and then Blade.
So killer? Is that what we're doing, you guys?
Here. Boy. Half the party attacking the Medusa sounds.
Yeah.
I mean, what else are we going to do? I don't know. Unless you have a spell to maybe let us run out.
Is she a beast or what?
She's a monstrosity, but I'll say since she's got snakes in her. Why?
I don't know.
Oh, okay. She's a kind of like half beast, but it's a certain thing in D&D called monstrosity, so not necessarily a beast.
If you guys can like lead her,
but if you have a cool
room...
thing that you can do to beasts, let me know and maybe it'll work.
Well, okay, I have the beast bond. The beast can understand your telepathic
messages.
Oh my god,
you can, yeah, cool. Her hair, you can do that to her hair.
Talk to her hair.
That's amazing. Yeah. That's amazing.
Give her an awesome wedding do.
Maybe the snakes can like strangle her.
Oh.
Clara. Oh, or bite her.
Clara.
Or bite her.
Okay. Okay. So can I do that?
You can bond with the, yeah. Yeah, sure. Okay. So you immediately bond and you develop a telepathic link. I'll just say with one of the snakes in her hair. Cause there
just
are
one.
Pick yeah. a good one.
How about if I tell the one snake to tell the other snake?
Okay.
Pass it on.
Like, hey, just do exactly what I do. And then telephone. I tell the snake.
Isn't the telephone game the whole way around her head?
And I'm like, hey, snake number one, bite her neck. And then he's going to tell his snake friend, hey, snake, bite her neck. I'm going to bite her neck. And you just have to copy me.
And be like, bite her dick. And then
kind neck. Of. I said neck.
Hey, okay. So this is a telepathic back and forth. And we'll say this is Cynthia. Cynthia says, Why would I do that? I love my mistress.
Well, your mistress likes it when you bite her in the neck. It's her new thing.
Cool. What? That's in a sexual way?
Right, and she has to get all ready for her wedding, okay? So you gotta put her in the mood and
it really
gets her going.
That's our job?
Yes, yes. And Fox is really into blood, so she has to be bleeding a lot, okay?
Wait, this is such new information.
Yes, you didn't know? First date, they watched Twilight together, and they're just super into all of that, okay?
First of all, they've never had a date before, but
in her dreams, okay? She had a dream. Oh, in her dreams. Right. Mm-hmm.
All right, Amy, this is wild. I'm going to do a... Go ahead and do...
My name is Tink, but it's okay.
Okay, Tink. Go ahead and do a persuasion check. And since I just like it, roll with advantage.
What do you mean roll with advantage?
So roll 2d20.
Oh, okay.
Take the higher of the two. Because I kind of hope this works, but I also need the dice to tell me that it does.
Twice? Do it twice?
Yeah, roll it
and
twice.
Then take the higher.
Take the higher, yeah.
Oh, fuck me. 11.
No, this is good.
That's the higher?
How many times can you guidance, Felicia?
I can guidance for, it's a cantrip, so I can give you a 1d4.
Is that
Tink? Tink, that was the 11 was the highest roll you had?
Yeah.
You rolled twice?
No. I rolled 11 and then I rolled 4.
Oh no!
Do you add anything? Was it persuaded?
Those are with my ad. My added.
Oh no!
Guidance is a cantrip at will.
Oh, at will? Yeah. Then
add a 1d4.
How hard is a hair snake to persuade? Really?
I mean, it's not. It's harder than 11.
3. Okay, so 14.
So 14. Okay, cool. That's enough for me. All right, great.
I can buy that.
It's harder than 11, but not as hard as 15. duh. Okay, cool. So Cynthia's like, yes, this makes all the sense in the world. And her snake, which I'm going to fake some stats for real quick, she's going to do it. And... Let's see. So Cynthia goes, my mistress, I hope this gets you wet.
Ooh. Go Cynthia.
And kind of bites here in her shoulder. It's not enough to kill her or hit an aorta or anything, but it does do what you want. It does make her bleed. And she does, you can see that she goes, ah, and she clutches her snake and her shoulder and takes some damage. So let's do that real quick. Cool. All right. Awesome. And you can hear Cynthia telepathically that she's also trying to get another snake on board.
Mm-hmm. Come on, everybody's doing it.
Yeah. So just so you know, Amy, I might have you control this, but right now you've got one snake on your side and it'll ideally exponentially increase, and each bite will do 1d4 piercing damage to Medusa.
Hey, this is great.
Yeah. This is nice.
That will turn the tide.
This is really cool. This should never have happened. Okay.
okay, so against all laws of nature.
But yeah, exactly. So this is Medusa's turn.
Guys, we got to get back to the rest of the party. I think they're beating some women up down there.
I think they're dead by now.
We really should have gone down there with them.
They're severely outnumbered.
Yeah.
Okay. So she's gonna look though at Tink. and say, "You did this," and she make a DC 14 Constitution saving throw.
Oh God, boy. We gotta get out of here, you guys.
I'm on the edge of my seat.
I think it, 4.
I'm sure we'll cut.
Wait, what? Really?
Did I do it right? I just clicked on the +1 under Constitution. Maybe I did it
wrong. No. Click on the saving throw, which is a little different. It's in the top left little square. It's a little red square.
The number would be the same unless you had proficiency in the saving throw.
Okay, 15.
Oh, I'm so tempted to take the 4. Okay, so you feel this, like the snakes kind of like pointed her to you, and she looks over at you, and you feel this incredible urge to like turn your gaze to meet hers, but there's something in you that is like, no, I'm not gonna do it. I'm gonna hold steady, and you focus instead on like something shiny in the room, like a little golden chalice, and you manage to avert the gaze, but she does come up to you, and she attacks you.
What?
Yep. Okay. Here's the thing. Let's say that she's got 20 snakes in her hair, and you've got one of them. This is going to be important to keep track of.
Okay.
Oh boy.
Okay. So.
What have we done?
Tink's got one. Medusa's got 19. That means that she can still, when she gets 10 or fewer snakes that she controls, she can't attack with her snake hair. So she's going to attack with her snake hair. Does a 14 hit you, Amy?
I'm 14.
So, meet or beat.
Meet or beat, yeah.
I just have to meet or beat. So I do hit you.
Oh, no.
And I do...
Ooh!
Ooh! Yeah. 4 piercing damage plus 14 poison damage. Ooh. So 18 damage.
Oh, that's smart.
That's a lot of damage.
Flex tape can't fix that.
Come on, Kodax.
Okay.
What are you down to?
Okay, Blades, it's your turn.
Okay, so I, still unseen, presently, I'm gonna try and all subtle-like get this cage open for Aristera's upstairs area, lady.
Listeria?
Okay. Ariola Steria.
So is that my thieves' tools? My sleight of hand?
Yeah, thieves' tools, sorry. Yes, thieves' tools, sleight of hand.
That was a hot 24.
Yes.
Wow.
Okay, so you're able to open the door. Medusa's currently engaged, and you're able to, open the door. The Ariel Asterio is still asleep, and she's weakened, but she kind of turns and jostles awake to look at you. Is there anything else you'd like to do?
Yeah, I just want to quickly like check over, make sure she's not like grievously physically harmed, so I can like kind of get her out of there.
Okay, yeah, you'd be able to get her out of there. It looks like, so you kind of try to help her stand up, and she's able to stand up. She just looks malnourished, really.
We've come to save you. Fox is here.
Okay, and you read, like, kind of blankness in her eyes, but she's like, thank you, you know, I, please save me.
Oh, no. Okay, come on.
She has sort of like a...
Yeah, and then yeah. Codex, you're up.
Okay, I'm going to go command. I'm going to cast command on the Medusa.
Okay.
And I'm going to say, what's the fastest way for us to get to the courtyard?
Man, there is a door.
Okay. There's a door. Okay.
Yeah, you know, you can see the geography of it. Like there's one door right.
So all we have to do is go out the door. That's that big door they have. Okay, great. Yeah. So I'm going to say point to the other door that we came in. Okay. And say and command her to run, and then I'm going to yell at everybody else, run out the other door.
Got it. Do I just
the target must it? Succeed on a wisdom throw.
Wisdom got saving it. Throw. Okay, let's do this.
Oh boy. I've
12.
No, 13.
13. Awesome. Okay.
Wow.
Okay,
great.
Awesome.
Okay.
So
great.
She does, and you say run. So on her next turn, she has to run, which is going to put her in. opportunity attack for Amy, for Tink. And
then I'm going to run out the door.
And you're just going to run out the door. That's great. That's a
And I'm awesome going to say, get out the door. And so okay. I want everybody to run and like get the party back together.
Okay, perfect. At that point, let's go ahead and merge. Let's merge because that's the end of your turn and that's the end of everyone else's turn. So mm-hmm. we're going to merge initiatives and it'll be, we're going to do the X's. We're going to do Tink.
The X's.
Medusa, Zabu, Clara, Fox, and then Blades and Codex. Y'all rolled low. Okay, so that's the fair. X's. You freed five of them. Now there are six of them, and it still says 10, 9, 8. So each one of them are going to try to hit you. It's for six, and I need, how much do I need? 17.
17.
15. Okay, cool. Wow. Five out of six of them hit.
Whoa. Oh, boy. You guys, I think I'm dead.
What? We gotta drag him out of here too.
What? Five out of six of them hit?
Out
of 17?
they have a plus five. I have to roll a 12 or higher. And
X's are well trained.
I mean he's attracted to a very strong type.
Yeah. Okay, so
all right, Codex Mellow.
16 damage to Fox.
Oh my god.
Cool. Tink, your
turn. So I have 5 hit points, y'all.
Oh jeez.
Okay.
If anybody great. Can heal me.
Okay. I got you. Maybe, yeah, okay, little fine.
Over here. Tink.
Just remember, I'm the one X who's helping you, okay?
So, is the Medusa gone? She's like, she left the room.
She will run on her next turn. You can
got it.
See that she's going to.
Wait, so this beast spawn thing, can I try to control another snake or not?
Yeah, you can, yeah. So another snake is already working its magic, so now she does have two, but if you try to control another snake, it's like gonna multi, it's gonna explode.
Yeah. Do that.
So go ahead. Okay, so let's do another persuasion. We've set the precedent. It's gotta get a 14 or higher and roll with the persuasion.
15.
Nice.
Yay.
Okay, so now we have three snakes and each one of them are gonna try to persuade another one. Perfect. So they're roll 3d4 and tell me how many hit points damage they do.
3
total?
Three. No. 9.
Nice. Okay. Cool math. Okay. Great. So, so three snakes now are like biting her shoulders and making her bleed. And, she's squirming, but, she's also, you can tell that she's somehow like her head is out of sorts and she's going to run up the stairs, based on Codex's command. Next we've got, next is the Medusa. She is going to run up the stairs. So Tink, you're in melee range and you get an attack of opportunity not with a bow, unfortunately though. So if you can make an attack with your dagger or rapier, whichever you want.
Rapier perfect. Is better?
It is better. Yes.
It is.
Yeah. Okay.
So roll a d20 and add 5.
14.
14 doesn't.
That's nothing to sneeze at.
Yeah, oh wait, that's your attack roll.
But it doesn't quite hit the Medusa. So as she's running by, you pull out your sword, you salute the snakes that you've convinced, especially Cynthia, and you swipe. But you're a little bit concerned with the snake saluting back, which you don't know how is happening. Okay, Zabu, you and Ruthie are up.
Okay, so has Medusa come, she's run to us, or where
no,
is she?
No, she's not in the courtyard. She ran up to the fourth floor.
The fourth, oh, but isn't that the balcony, or no? Do I see her?
Yeah, the balcony. I guess you could, you from the courtyard can see her kind of running along the viewing platform.
Okay, and then, since Fox is being beaten by his exes, that's happening right now. Okay, Oh, I feel like I gotta get his X's off of him. Otherwise, he's gonna die.
You sound so enthusiastic about helping him.
Well, you know.
I mean, I'm siding a little bit with the X's here.
My heart's for Codex, too. And, oh, man.
I'm not into him. But
what's that?
I'm not into him.
Yeah, okay.
Well, he's not into you, so I'm not that threatened by him. Sorry. Man, here's what I'm gonna. There's five of them. How do I handle five of them?
There's six of them technically.
There's six of well, one of them is like backed off, right?
Yeah. Oh, you're right. Yes.
Could you do like you want to do like a minor illusion or a disguise self to?
I'm thinking. Throw them off? Yeah. I'm gonna do a minor illusion of another fox across the room, and who basically says, "That's not the real fox. I'm the real fox. If you got problems with fox, you gotta come over to this fox." Foxes.
Oh, that's so sweet.
Wow.
That is nice.
Also, that was sounds good. Just like him.
Yeah. Exactly. Best impression ever. Like
it takes amazing. Him 20 minutes to say that, though.
Let me ask you, Edis, do you want to describe what he's wearing or what he looks like? I remember the last time you made a party member. That was very specific.
Yeah, so he's wearing just a flowing kilt. The old fox, and he's freeballing it. There are no undies. There's nothing, nothing.
He's not painting for inspiration there.
Yeah, okay. Exactly. And he's just got, for whatever reason, just one nipple, like just, he's got one breast just out, and it's just man pecked out. Super. It's got ripples with it. His pec looks like it has abs.
Highland oh my sex God. To
okay,
see.
Awesome. What is your spell save DC? Because I need to roll.
It's not great. It's 11.
Oh, 11? Okay.
Yeah.
Two, three, four. Four of them believe you. And you can or believe your illusion at least. The other one is like, nah. So so on their turn, they're gonna run towards the illusion, which if you want Fox, when that happens, you can take an attack of opportunity, but it's Clara's turn at the moment.
Oh great. Well,
acid.
But I don't want to kill it. It's so bad.
God.
Okay. Well, here's the thing.
Give me healing spells or no?
I don't know. I mean, I have a mage hand, so can I like swamp like poof them away? Can I do that?
Mage hands won't. I mean, it wouldn't do as it. Yeah, you're trying to do. If you're
I don't want
to
hurt
non-lethal.
Them.
Like it wouldn't do. It wouldn't do much damage to an actual.
Would it like get them away from him?
Yeah, you could use
that's
it to.
What I want
to
do.
Yeah, you could use it to push him away. So maybe just the one girl, right? Yeah. The one who's not who's still focused on left. Him.
Yeah.
Perfect. Okay. Cool. So one of these, like, hey, stop fighting.
Yeah.
awesome. So real, I guess that's just, we'll just do like strength, like contest of strength, and we'll make your mage hand have your charisma bonus instead. So roll a d20 and add 3.
Okay.
And I'll roll a d20. I got 5.
Oh no.
I got 12.
Nice. Okay.
That's more than 5.
Yeah, that is what happens. You know, she's trying to fight, but your hand is holding her at bay. But she doesn't quite move. She's just unable to like swat at your friend Fox, whose turn it is. Okay. So Fox, what would you like to do?
Have I seen the Medusa running away? Did I see all of that business happen?
Yeah, you could have, yeah.
Okay, and the rest of the party are we pretty spread out?
That's a good question. It looks like Clara's pretty far from you, but Zabu, yeah, they're not like.
I pulled the lever. I pulled the first lever.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, y'all are both there. Yeah, I'd say everyone's kind of in the middle of the room around the lever.
Okay.
But the rest of your party, the other three aren't quite to you yet.
Okay, so first Fox looks at Zabu and says, "I deserve this."
I know, man. It's I agree. But we need to keep you alive so you can pay us the 100 gold coins.
But I cannot turn this off. You understand.
No, I'm sure. Yeah. Yeah. God, you're the worst.
I don't really want to hurt anybody, but I think we got to get after this. We got to get up. We got to get after this this Medusa. So I'm gonna unarmed strike the angry exits closest to me just to like get off to get away. So that is gonna be. That's going to be an 11.
Okay, actually, I'll let you roll with advantage because she's being restrained by a mage hand.
Oh, so much better. That is a 16.
Okay, perfect. Hey. Yeah, totally. Hey. Your unarmed strike
rolled a team.
Hits. So I think that's a d4?
It's a 4, it's just 4 points bludgeoning.
Just 4 points bludgeoning. Yeah. Okay, great. That's enough. That's enough to like smack her out of her. Wow, it does a lot of damage to you. These women aren't. They're not. They're just regular girls. They're not like adventurers. So you smack her, and she actually like falls to the ground, and you can tell that you've done like a significant.
I mean, he's a douchebag, but he's not that kind of douchebag.
Whoa.
Totally. But you stopped her in her tracks and she hit you first.
The DM is more in favor of it than the character is.
For the kids? For the kids? Question mark? Okay, so great. Awesome. Is there anything else you want to do?
Hang on a second. I saw. I don't need to do that. Do I have enough time to talk?
Yeah, for sure.
Great. So I just say to Zabu, or I just shout out, we've got to get the Medusa.
I agree. How many statue people are around still left? Out of curiosity.
Good question. One, Foro has kind of stopped. I mean, this is all happening very quickly, but she stopped attacking. 4 of them have gone towards your minor illusion, and 1 is on the ground. The lever countdown is on 5, 4, 3.
Yeah, what's happening? We've never gotten to 1, huh?
Also, how many statues are still left?
About 7.
Oh my God.
It's not open anymore.
Why didn't you keep it in your pants a little bit more? This is my courtyard would be 1, 2, maybe. 1.5. I don't know what happened that one time.
2.5. Wow.
My courtyard.
Okay, whose turn is it? Well, what do we do?
I think it's that. Oh, no, it's not. Sorry. Yeah, if you're done, Fox, Blades, you're up.
All right, so I've got Area, Stereo. And I'm just trying to, I'm trying to get her out the door, into the courtyard, just helping her along, and I'm going to call out to Fox and the whole crew, we got to get out of here, guys, I've got her!
Okay.
And then, I'm just going to keep heading out.
Okay, so you kind of walk past and avoid the fray in the courtyard?
Yeah, I'm dodging X's.
Okay, awesome.
Dodging X's. I'm bobbing and weaving.
How long? Oh, okay. So, great. Yep, you're able to do that, and she's willing to follow you. Okay, so she's just like, yeah, great. I'm glad you're rescuing me. And
from this position, also like now, like in and a little bit past the group, do we all have eyes on the Medusa still, or has she since gone out of sight?
No, she. I mean, she can only run how much? Like 60 feet. So she made it kind of up the stairs into a viewing point.
So she's not behind glass anymore.
Sorry?
She's not behind glass anymore?
Yeah, she is behind
glass.
She ran up the stairs to the 4th floor balcony. But yeah, so you can see her. The way command works is it lasts for a round.
Right. By the way. So if I may, I just want to see, once I reach the end of my movement and I say that phrase, I want to try and shoot with my crossbow at her to see if I can break the glass.
Awesome. Okay. So yes, roll to hit And the glass has some, has a, yeah, has an armor class.
All right, great. That's going to be a hot.
Is what you're trying to hit.
That's a 16.
16 hits. 16 hits. And if it does hit, it breaks the glass, but kind of like a bullet. So it makes, we'll say it breaks about 10 feet worth of glass and it shatters on her. So that's another 2d4 damage of piercing damage. Nice work. 3, 4, 7. Great. So she's still up, but yeah, you shoot your air. You're like, you're running with Air Sarah and you shoot, you take your bow and it's like Hunger Games with Katniss. You shoot up at the Medusa and you break the glass. It shatters into her and you see it piercing her just as badly as the snakes are piercing her.
Wow.
So she's carrying a hot
wood elf the whole time. Oh boy.
Fades to the rescue, huh?
So, cross in one hand, wood elf in the other.
Oh boy.
Her wedding dress is bloody. She looks like, yeah, total horror movie. Codex, you're up.
All right. Well, I see that Fox is hurting. And I look around the courtyard and I was like, is that what? I'm sorry. Is that my ex-nanny up there? The one we had dinner with on our second date? Is that my ex-nanny? Is that Martha?
Yes.
He's resigned to it.
Okay. Yep. Whatever, dude. Okay, so I go over.
No, wait, hold on. Why were you having dinner with your ex-nanny on a Sunday?
I didn't want to ask.
I always, she has to screen people. That's why I only had intercourse with 1.5 people my whole life.
Got it.
She was her nanny until you were like 24.
Yeah, exactly. I had a nanny. Until,
oh, she was your nanny, like nannying you.
Yeah, she was my nanny, but I had her through college because I just, I couldn't, I just needed help. Okay. This is why I can't, my apartment is so dirty. All right. I don't know how to clean by myself.
Perfect. Okay. Yeah, it's Martha.
Great. Okay. Well, Fox, I think we'll talk about that later. And then I'm going to go ahead and use a healing spell on him. I'm going to do a, I'm going to do a cure wounds. And so a creature you touch, a 1d8 plus your spell classing. So I'm going to do, if I could get this thing to work, it's going to be 6 points of healing that he takes.
Thank you.
Awesome. All right. So he's a little more healed. And we're back to the top. The X's go towards the minor illusion and they swat at him. They do find out that he's a fake, but no more damage is done to the real Fox. Tink, it's your turn again.
Well, Codex, just want to let you know, thanks for not healing me. I'm fine. Don't worry about me. Whatever. It's cool. The magic of dick, huh?
I just, listen.
Is
that the name of this session?
I forgot that you were wounded. I literally forgot you were wounded.
Of course
but I saw...
you forgot because you could only think about Fox.
Okay, it's true. It's true. This is a problem.
Magic of Dick, a new D&D module.
I'm really sorry. I could have done that thing with my Bertha toe and heal both of you at the same time. Actually, I could have done more healing. If I could just go back in time, I would have given you 8 points of healing and him 7.
So. It's okay. Nice to want things.
Oh boy. Okay. We'll talk about later. Well. Yeah. Okay.
So Medusa's gone out of my sight, huh?
Yeah, she's out of your sight, yeah, because you're still in the tower.
Join us.
Yeah, okay. I'll go. Can I like jump through the shattered glass, like, and just hop into the third floor?
You make an entrance.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, hell yeah.
Okay. Hey guys.
Wow.
Hey.
Oh,
hi.
I'm so in a lot of pain, but somehow I jumped floors.
Oh wait.
You did it so gracefully.
I forgot you were wounded. Sorry, Tink.
I should probably, should I attack some X's, huh?
Well,
There's Medusa is also there.
They're aggressive, yes, but they, you know.
Oh, I thought I couldn't see the Medusa, but now I can see the Medusa.
You're in the courtyard. Everyone can see.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Let's attack the Medusa. Great. I wanna talk to another snake, please.
Yes. Okay, persuasion. Yes. So each one of these is converting another one. So now you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And let's see if you grab another bad boy. Persuasion with advantage.
Persuasion with advantage. What does that mean again?
Two of them. Two.
Two. Okay, great. Because that was bad. That one's worse. 6.
Yeah, no. So yeah, you're talking to another snake and they're like, God dang it, Missy.
Harsh.
Well, maybe if you healed me, I would have rolled better.
Okay, wow.
Fair enough. That was your movement and your action. Now it's the Medusa's turn. Okay. So she looks down. She's no longer in the command. So she like stops, turns, looks at the courtyard. Blades, you're running with Aristera, and you can see that she's like running along with you. But as you turn to shoot up your bow and arrow, she also turns and it looks hard, but she looks up at the Medusa and turns to stone.
Oh, for crying out loud.
In my very hands.
That's what the Medusa does.
If you're not, I mean, she's dumb. That's your true love? She looked right up at it. She's been hanging out with the Medusa for weeks and she looks up at her?
To be fair, Tink observed the exact same treatment. The Medusa kind of forced her to look.
She gets in your head, yo.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, she gets in her head. Mm-hmm. So then the Medusa makes an announcement and she goes, all right, I see that you've come for me, Fox. Finally, I wasn't ready. I needed to do a lot more research to make myself desirable for you. But you jumped the gun and here I am. I'm ready. Yes, I froze all of your dalliances, I'll call them, because they're threats to my love for you.
Rose.
I imprinted on you. My snakes imprinted on you when you were a mere boy. Ooh. And you've been mine, even though you didn't know it, since then.
Ooh, boy.
And that's what she does for her turn. She doesn't actually... Yeah, she's not near enough to do snake attacks. Mm.
Well, ain't that a pickle?
Do y'all still... are y'all still trying to fight her, or do you want to break combat?
I mean,
want to talk to her.
I'd like the lowdown. We've been doing a lot.
Let's do some lowdown stuff.
Let's do some lowdown because this is something else.
Yeah. Can I say something to her?
Yeah.
As a fellow stalker.
Oh, boy.
Zabu is the most qualified for this conversation.
I lift up my sequined hand to look at her in the eyes. Through the reflection.
Oh, I see. Okay.
And say, Dana, I know how it feels to be obsessed with someone so beautiful and who's you're so perfect for, and she just doesn't know it yet. But like, you know, she knows deep down she loves you, but she's not aware of it. Like, I get how you feel, but this isn't the way. This isn't the way to do it. Because like, look, if you get too like. I get it. I've been obsessed to the point that I became a zombie over my obsession to hang out with Codex. I'm gonna turn if you get
don't blame your zombieism on me. Okay, like listen, this is okay. We'll talk about it later.
You're stacking up some conversations, Codex.
Yeah, really. I'll put you on the list. I'll put you on the schedule.
So I don't know. I mean, I don't want you to zombify yourself over this obsession.
Well, let me ask you this. Did your way get you your love?
Well, we became friends. And sure, the friend zone kind of blows, but I mean, at least I get to hang out with other cool friends.
It's a work in progress.
And we all adventure together.
Oh my gosh.
Look at you. You're just freezing everybody.
I know.
And you must be lonely.
It wouldn't be lonely. It's all for a purpose. It's to get Fox, and then I won't be lonely. The thing is I have to render every single woman that he finds attractive obsolete.
Ooh, and I guess that's why Codex wasn't
what? No, wait a minute. I'm sorry, ma'am.
Just kind of putting that together.
Hey, ma'am, I want to ask you, like, my name's Codex, and if you maybe had a blind spot, was there a year that maybe you took a tour to, like, across another continent, and you forgot that there might have been another affair, you know, like me?
I was very aware of you.
So why didn't I ever get a spa invitation? You didn't freeze me. Not that I want to be frozen, but this is my nanny, Martha, and there's a lot here, but I'm not here, and I just wanted to know why, like, you know, you left me out. Just wondering.
I mean, if it's not obvious, you're no threat.
I mean, Fox was the first. I was the first person that Fox came to.
Yeah,
I'm
but
sorry,
he never actually cared about you.
What?
Oh,
at all?
Jamie, you know, it doesn't hurt.
No, did you read his journal? Did you read his journal during the times?
And I have spies everywhere.
Fox, is that true? Am I the only one you really didn't care about?
Codex. Nothing exists.
Oh, no.
Oh, here we go. No. Even if something exists, nothing can be known about it.
Oh, man, slow down.
And even if something can be known about it,
what?
Knowledge about it can't be communicated to others.
Well, that convinced me.
Tink, I am so sorry I didn't heal you.
Yeah, well.
Now, listen, Fox. My love, my only, you came here on your own volition, but now I must make an ultimatum. Either marry me right now, today, be mine forever, or I kill Aristera.
God, they're kind of made for each other. They both talk so slowly.
They really take their time.
It might be
elocution. They make every word count, which is the opposite of my approach. I mean, I just say all of them and nothing matters.
The only other option is to choose Aristera, in which case I will freeze both of you together.
I mean, that's kind of poetic.
Damn.
There's a third option.
Three options.
I just got two. What, you can come up with the third.
No, it's marry her or Aristera dies, or they get frozen together forever.
There was three.
You're right. Well, anyway,
yeah, guys, I'm
an Indian
saying...
gnome. We're good at math.
We should do this, or that this is like the option, but what if we just like gave him to her? Like, do we need?
Well, we don't get 100 gold pieces.
Wait, so. I just want to know why. That's Fox. A lot of trouble. This is a long game, lady, and I don't know the maybe the lifespan of a Medusa is a couple hundred years, so this is still a significant long game. Like, why Fox? Why did you pick him out? Why is he special?
I imprinted on him. They say that the heart wants what the heart wants, and it's what I want. I was drawn to him at a young age. I knew he'd turn into this really freaking hot guy, and I was
That's
all
a
about
weird
it.
Thing
okay,
to
I'm gonna.
And
you know what? Wait.
I was all
question,
about
question,
it.
Question. While she's talking, is she still? She's talking to us from above, right?
Yeah.
So I'm like, I'm gonna interrupt her and command her to fall.
I don't think it can make her put herself in harm's way, right?
Can it? Oh yeah, it's directly harmful to it.
Is it directly harmful? Yeah.
Also, that'd be hilarious though.
It would
make
be funny
to a mirror, make her look at herself.
Yeah
Well, that would harm her, right?
Oh yeah, I guess.
Fuck it, just do it.
just do it.
Okay, I'm gonna roll. What is it, a wisdom saving
wisdom
throw?
Yeah, 13
wisdom saving throw. Oh no, 18.
No, ball.
Bomb. 7 o'clock.
Go! This is my glory moment. Codex stops and I'm like, you won't ignore me. I'm formidable. I am lovable, and God damn it, I'm worth it. Fall.
Agree.
Oh,
no, I don't think good. I don't think I'll do that.
How, real quick, how heavy is the Aristeria statue?
She gave, she like, she's like 15 pounds heavier. So, yeah.
Okay, I'm just gonna pop the statue on my shoulder and start like working my way toward the door.
Okay, yeah, you can do that. She says, "You fools, you think you can escape? The only escape you'll get is if I get Fox to myself alive or frozen forever. Fox, what is your choice?"
Let's just cheese it.
How far away from her am I?
About 60 feet.
All right.
Does she look wounded?
I mean, she's bleeding. She's like, she's bloody.
Are those snakes still like going at her?
Yeah.
So she could be taken down, guys.
Yeah, let's say that the snakes are still going at her.
I just thought of a really good idea.
Oh, acid? Clara, go for it.
Well, not acid, but zombie, Zombie Zabu is wearing like reflective stuff, right?
Yeah.
Why can't someone throw his zombie self up towards? Yeah, Ruthie chucks Zambu up towards Dana, and then she sees herself in his.
Make her freeze herself.
Yeah.
The reflection.
That's what I was saying. Make her look at herself.
Can we do that?
Oh my gosh.
I want to throw Zambu.
The actual rules, that would work.
Nobody tosses a gnome.
Let's do it. Gnome tossing.
Okay. Ruthie is a troll. Ruthie's pretty freaking strong.
Yeah.
She's athletic as hell. Ugly, but athletic. And she's in a like sequin blue skin tight dress that may as well be a Speedo because she's ripped through it.
Okay. Horrifying. Let's see.
Amazing.
Okay, and Zabor, you're assisting her, right? Like you're just like light as a feather, stiff as a board.
I mean,
yeah, I am sort of like, I mean, is there any chance that you might be attracted to her and want to marry her, Fox, or do I have to do this gnome toss?
Just
want to know. Maybe she's the one.
I cannot give you my heart. Dana.
Okay, toss me.
It belongs.
Okay.
It belongs to another. And grabs Zabu.
Oh. He doesn't.
And he looks at Ruthie and he goes, on three.
Oh my God. Okay, you're together. Awesome. Ruthie goes, I was born for this. I forgot. So Will, go ahead and roll with advantage. Roll athletics. Feels like we're gonna be tossing a softball.
18.
Oh my God.
That's good.
When it counts.
The dice want this.
Literally, rules say if the Medusa sees itself reflected on a polished surface, within 30 feet of it and in an area of bright light, the Medusa is, due to its curse, affected by its own gaze.
Oh my God, this is amazing.
Yeah. Y'all broke it. Okay.
Clara.
You did it. You're so good, Clara. Okay. So yes, Zabu. So on three, we've got Fox and we've got Ruthie. And they go one, two, three. And they launch Zambu.
It's beautiful.
Al Lim is still in Ruthie's hand, maybe a leg. And Zabu kind of like flies through the air. And
it's reflecting like a disco ball.
Yeah, the entire surface of him is reflecting. And even though it's a little convoluted the way fish scales are reflected, she does get a glimpse of one perfect round sequin that is just her face. And she can't look away. In fact, a flying zombie Zabu is really compelling. And she sees herself in the mirror. And as she does, just a confused and curious look on her face is frozen as the rest of her also freezes, including the snakes on her head.
Wow.
She did it.
As she freezes, the other exes and Aristera unfreeze and come back to life.
And
a bunch of them attack Will and he goes down, but he's just unconscious.
and then the rest of us catch Zambu, right? Zambu.
Oh, yeah. The rest of you.
I was picturing him hitting the board.
I like the idea of just falling on Fox just as he's getting pounded.
Feeling the final point of damage.
He lurches.
You're the final point of damage. Yeah, you actually shoot the fart out of him, and that's when he goes unconscious.
And you know what? Wait. I'm going to stand up, and I'm going to be look, ladies, listen. My name is Codex, and I'm evidently the one woman he didn't give a shit about. And I just want you guys to know he is not worth it, okay? He might have a luscious beard and a physique that, you know, rivals any Grecian, elven statue that but he's a piece of trash. Martha, girl, I'm gonna have to talk to you afterwards, but just know that you guys are powerful. He is not worth a kick, a bruised toe, anything. Just walk out of here, ladies, and go and have intercourse with a guy or a girl or any kind of beast, creature, whatever's legal. Just go out and find somebody who actually cares about you.
Wow.
That's my speech.
Slow clap. Okay?
I'm moved.
There we go.
Every that's word awesome. Counted.
Yeah.
Actually, we're helping you clap.
Okay, thank you.
We each grab one of Zombu's hands to clap with.
Thanks, guys. Thank you.
Yeah, it you know, the speech works. You know, Martha looks at you very proudly and says, I'll see you back in Mondopolis, girl, but I'm proud of you. You taught me more than Sekwaf Spa ever did. I'm going to go and love myself.
Thank you, Martha. You taught me this. Also, you slept with my ex-boyfriend. Thank you.
Yeah.
Talk about this later.
Yeah, I did.
Okay, great. And he cared about you more than me. So,
bye. Yeah, the women, the sad women that Sekwaf Spa was built around, was able to, actually somehow they did manage to heal these women, but it wasn't because of the Medusa. It was because of Codex herself. And that's where we'll end the game. You know, Fox is unconscious, but that doesn't mean he's uncurable. He got what was coming to him, and we'll see. Maybe one day we'll see what happens to him and Aristera if they actually do stick together or what.
Did Aristera stay? Does she stay?
Well, if you talk to her.
I'm going to talk to her.
Yeah.
Hey, Aristera, because I've still got her right here.
Yeah, you still got her. Yeah. So she's like kind of wasted.
Oh, no,
she's like,
this is not going
Aristera,
well for Fox.
Hi. Yeah. I'm sure you heard my little speech, but I do want you to know that of all the times I've known Fox, of all the women in this room, you're the only one he really fought for. So I'm not telling you to get together with him. He's obviously got a stinky pee-pee because it's been around. But I would tell you.
Check that.
Yeah, you want to check it upstairs and downstairs.
Yeah.
But at the same time, I've never seen him care or go out of his way for anybody but himself. So I don't know. It might work, might not. But he is unconscious.
Okay, I'm just going to stop you there.
Yeah.
So he was just a hookup for me.
I'm so excited to hear you say that.
Oh, wait, when he's unconscious, he doesn't hear it.
Oh, no. I'm going to lay on hands and I'm going to be like, wait, can you repeat that?
No, I'm going to go. I feel like I was targeted for the wrong reason and this was never going to work out. And I mean, we all make mistakes and he was mine.
Mistake?
Wow.
Just an old Fortnite stand. Real quick, can I get your number? You want to grab coffee?
How do you feel about roguey former fry cooks?
Oh, boy.
Yeah, I mean...
Animals.
Yeah,
animals.
Totally fine, I guess. I need some rest, but also...
No, go get space.
Yeah, no, totally.
I'm just inspired to be over Codex
as well. I think we hooked up twice.
Oh, wow. He really made it out.
Who's going to break this to him when he wakes up?
None of us could really work. We're going to leave him. So bye. I'll leave a little note. Be like, see ya.
No, we want that gold.
What's your gold?
Oh, yeah. We do need the gold.
Oh, well, check his pockets.
Does he have it on his person?
Search his pockets.
Go through his stuff. Yeah.
Get the pocket. Get the gold.
Okay. Yeah, he's got it on his person.
Perfect. 100% carries a man purse.
I cut it off him and I'm like, ooh, burn, baby. He's going to wake up and be a little depressed.
And I think that's where we're going to end it.
Bye.
No better time.
Fox will wake
up. Oh, so perfect. He's such a douchebag.
But he is at a spa. He'll wake up in a spa.
He'll be fine. It'll be serene.
Yeah. Maybe
Wrapping up, I just wanted to thank you so much for letting me be part of this. Felicia,
you were so fun. Oh my God, this was so fun, you guys.
For DMing. Gildies, I haven't seen you guys in so long.
Years.
And it just makes me so happy to see you guys. And this evening has reminded me of all the incredibly fun times we had together when we were fucking changing the world with the guild, when we were like building the groundwork for the world of like online media that exists right now. Like we were part of something so special, and I love that we are forever connected because of this really amazing thing that you made, Felicia.
We all made it together. I cannot claim credit. It was a group effort, and it was so wonderful to have you.
100% in your inspiration and your baby, and you entrusted pieces of it to us. And I just had a great time tonight, and it's just awesome to see you guys. And thank you. I'm just really happy that I got to play and be part of this.
We would love to have you back when we come back.
Wait, so, guys, we can't end without singing happy birthday.
Oh
my God.
Yeah.
It's all completely out of sync.
It's my birthday.
Over Zoom.
Happy birthday to you. Okay, great.
We can edit that out of the YouTube video.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Will. We'd love to have you back. So Amy is traveling. Other people are traveling. So we'll be updating about our future streams. We're hoping to come back for a couple in August. So stay tuned. Go to my Discord, discord.gg/FeliciaDay. There's an awesome community there. Amy and I stream, so if you want to follow her, Amy Okuda, and we're going to be streaming on Tuesday night, so come back and we'll be playing some Terraria or something like that. Will streams as well, and all of us are just, we love you guys so much. This has literally gotten me through my quarantine. This really was the highlight of all the weeks that we've done this. Thank you guys. I love all of you. You are so brilliant. You make me laugh more than anything. And my cheeks hurt literally the next day. Amy, thank you for being an incredible DM. Thank you, Amy.
That was wonderful.
And we're going to raid somebody who has very few followers. Starkel Plays, we're gonna raid right now. And I just want to thank Sean Becker behind the scenes and all of our mods. Everybody go over there and make somebody's day. Last night we did a raid and the woman was literally crying for an hour. It was so awesome. That you guys, and this, you know, it really makes a day. So thank you. We'll see you Tuesday night. Thanks everybody. Anybody else have anything to say? No? All right.
Well, I mean, thank you for doing this. Thank you for being here. And it was awesome.
Yeah. Thanks for having me.
Thanks, Will. Thanks. Good to see you.
Right now. Go. Leave. Bye.